that to work.
How'd I get my other camera to work?
This is working right here. And that's why I brought this. Aiden, it's only showing your feed. How do I get it back on this camera? Okay. Oh, that's dead.
I can get it running. Did you look at that picture of your mother?
Yeah.
think we're live, ladies and gentlemen. We will see. We're not professionals by any sort, so Aiden, I'm going to hand you my phone and go in there, see if you can pull up the stream, make sure we got audio. Maybe somebody can text me and let me know. Morgan's going to pull it up here in just a second. 1972. All right, we're here with the lovely Morgan Keith. I don't know why I don't call you Wombles for, Keith.
What?
You just seem like a Morgan. I think I knew one from Clay County that was a Morgan.
Wombles?
Saw that work. Yeah, Wombles. So we don't have any Wombles over in Pulaski, do we? Very few. So, all right, we'll see if we got audio or not. Pulling up to ears, so no audio.
Wait, yeah, we did. It's like really delayed.
Okay. All right, match number one. So what we're going to do, fans, here today, I've got the talented and lovely Morgan Keith with me. Morgan, they're warming up, and they're about ready to go. The one thing I do like is the ball holders over there to let us know the score, because we're not always paying attention to know if it's 15 love or 30 all or add out or add in. So it's good having a tennis player here to talk tennis about. But over here at number one single, so I'll have to get the Southwestern's players' names here in just a second off my phone. But That's Jackson Flynn, okay. So on court number one, we got Ben Hepton against Jackson Flynn. On court number two, we're going to have, is this C.J. Heist? Yeah. C.J. Heist, and I'll have to get the Southwestern's player. So, Morgan, let's come back a little bit here while they're warming up and tell us a little bit about the tennis team, you know, and girls are going to play later today. So I don't know how long you're going to stay here, but, you know, we're sort of nominating Savannah Heist for Breakthrough Player of the Year because she's undefeated right now.
Yeah.
So maybe you can talk about leaps and bounds and how she's grown. But, you know, our men's team here are actually really young, so we're going to be good for several years in a row. So maybe tell us a little bit about Coach Atkinson and how you guys practice and warm up and play. And it seems to be picking up because look at all the players over there.
Yeah, for sure. See, when I started playing or wanted to play, I didn't even know the tennis team was a thing. I had Coach Atkinson in pre-cal, and he talked to me about joining the classroom and just going out for open courts or whatever, and I was really hesitant because I had never picked up a tennis racket in my life, okay? So I get out here my junior year, and we start practicing, and I was really bad, actually, like super bad. And Coach told me that it takes time and whatever. Well, we were a couple practices in and started doing the conditioning. Now, that was tough. Like, I play volleyball, softball. I knew that conditioning was tough, but tennis conditioning is running, and I am not a runner, okay? I mean, we had to do, like, short sprints, long sprints. It was tough. But I really do, now that I'm graduated and haven't done those conditioning, I ain't as good as tennis I once was. I'm not as fast. So it definitely is useful with his conditioning. You don't think it is in the time until you're out of it. But – yeah, so I really do think, like you said, it has grown a lot. There was probably half the amount of players we had when I started, and we were pretty deep my first year. I mean, we had Jackson and Catherine and Lauren and Caroline, so we were pretty deep my first year that I played, my junior year. The next year was just as deep, and I feel like they just keep getting deeper every single year. Like, you think when you leave, you're like, oh, you're losing a lot of seniors, but really we only lost a couple last year. So, yeah, these young players, like, this is his first year playing, and he's probably better than a lot of seniors that are on other teams, C.J. Heist. So, and so is Ben, but Ben's a little bit older. But even Aiden Webb, he's really good too. I mean, I see these young players, I'm just like, how? Like, I wish I would have started earlier, you know. But I think Coach kind of has that we want to win mentality. That's what kind of keeps the players here. And he doesn't goof around. He's serious every single day. He does goof around a lot, but he's very serious when it comes to tennis, and you almost can't talk to him during a match day. He's real, real stressed out.
Well, I think they've already started this match here because Ben looks a little frustrated because that was a double fault on that serve, Morgan. He served one about through the fence and went with a big kick serve there and missed it on the second serve. So I don't know what the score of the particular game is, but I do think the match has started here on court number one. So, fans, what we're going to do today is we're going to try to get you some action from all four games going on. Obviously not at the same time, but since we'll get our second camera up, we'll be able to flip around a little bit from singles to doubles action. So, oh, nice backhand volley right there. 30-15 or 15-30? Okay, so big on the first service game of the match whenever you're down. So Morgan's calling it 15-30 here. So is he indeed serving on the deuce court? Looks like he is. So you could be right. We'll go ahead and walk our way through this.
Already.
Okay, good first serve. Jackson Flynn gets it back. Ben decides to go up. That looks like one I tried to kill right there, but coming back. Flint's one of those, oh, nice one right down the baseline. Okay, add in. So Morgan said it. So game number one to what's the biggest thing that impresses you so far with Ben Hampton's game?
So one thing that I've noticed, like, even when I first started watching him play, was that he, like you said, you think you would have killed that one. He's very good at kind of, like, getting the players going. Like, he wants to go short some balls. He wants to hit them hard some balls. He wants to go long and kind of get them flustered a little bit, and then he'll hit that winner shot.
Yeah, that's one thing you got to enjoy. What a beautiful day out here. And you know, I was talking to Coach about this, and I don't know what it's ever going to take, but if we could get two more courts out here, it would make such a difference, because you got one coach being the men's and the women's coach, and there's just not enough courts, especially if you try to work in a JV match here or there. And you know, it's nice now we got the extra hour of daylight. But well, CJ hit a nice high. Ooh, nice one. That one was right at the baseline, so I don't know what they're going to call here. So you guys can't see. We're watching court two, accommodating on court two while the camera's on court number one. Is that his feet? Is sort of a hard one for us to see there, Morgan, for things to go. So Jackson Flynn's ready for a serve. Big lefty coming up here. So looks like it's a let. So he'll get two serves here again. So Ben Hampton up 1-0 in game number one. There's Mr. Dalton coming over with resources for us, Morgan, to eat here in a few minutes. Jackson Flynn went down the baseline, and Ben missed a volley at the net. So I know Ben's going to be a little frustrated at that one.
Yeah, that's one thing. When you're – tennis is one of those sports. Like, I've recently gotten into pickleball, and it's one of those sports that I don't care if I lose. If I lose, I lose. I mean, it's just so much fun to play. Now, don't get me wrong, tennis is so fun to play, but I get so frustrated. I guess where I've played competitively for so many years, I just have to win. And so Coach has got me in these leagues that I'm in, and I'm actually starting a new one this week. And I actually hate when I lose. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. So when I play tennis, it's so hard to, like, not get in your head, because it's really a big mental game. I mean, a lot of sports really are big mental games, like most sports actually. But tennis is one of those ones where it's all on you. I mean, every ball you have to have a perfect setup to be able to really not get in your head and hit that shot.
All right, folks, hold on a second. We're going to be right back. We're going to work on our audio here. We said a little buzzing sound, so we'll change the cable, see if that fixes anything or not. You go right ahead. All right, so we should be back with audio, so we'll make sure. We got 10 viewers, Morgan, so it looks like it's picking up here. So we got 10 as well. But you were speaking earlier, and hopefully the broadcast is still on pickleball. So I think I told you this back in high school. I was a tennis player, so that's why I really, really enjoy tennis. That was definitely why. So for CJ Heist here on the court. So my next chapter in life, I'm still playing basketball. Morgan, I'm old. I'm 51, so it's getting to be old to play sports. But it's never too old for tennis and racquetball and pickleball and those fun things. So if I wanted to start a brand new sport, a pickleball, what would I do and where would I go?
So you've never played pickleball?
Never.
Yeah, so if you're, like, decent at tennis, you don't even have to be good. If you're decent at tennis, you're going to be great at pickleball. Like, I started my very first time ever playing, and they were like, how long have you been playing? My first time, sir, you know? Yeah, like you said, there's definitely sports that you can and can't play once you start getting older, but pickleball is one of those ones that I play with people that are 80 years old and that are still out there pushing. I mean, they're obviously, like, not as mobile as they were, but it's just such a fun sport. I mean, the paddles are not even that expensive. You don't have to have the best one. It's all in your game, really. Just don't get a wooden paddle. That's all I ask. but, yeah, just you got to hit the ball a lot harder. Like, it's like if you're one of those players that like to shoot the moon and, like, hit that tennis ball, you're going to be really good at pickleball because you're able to hit it really as hard as you want, put some spin on it, and really get your players going.
So what's the difference in the actual ball? When we talk about a tennis ball, when we talk about a pickleball, what's the difference in the balls?
Well, tennis ball will carry more. It's it'll go longer. Obviously, it's heavier, and your racket is like string, so it's gonna like bounce off the strings. Now, pickleball, it's gonna carry with air, so it's not gonna go as far. It's also gonna slow down in the air, but you can also do a lot more like fun things with it, like. you can put back, like you obviously put backspin on it or whatever, but you can almost like stop them in the air. Like tennis balls, you can't do that, but pickleballs, you can literally like hit it, you can slice it at the perfect time and perfect spot, and it's gonna like almost stop in the air. It's pretty cool.
Well, I think you missed that one right there, Morgan. You were looking at me, telling me about pickleball. Ben Hampton had an excellent half volley right there, and a lot of times that looks a lot easier on TV than it does in real action, but that was down at his feet, and he took it off the racket and got a winner across the net, so it was a really good shot by Ben Hampton here. And you know what? So impressed with my man Kevin Hampton and Wendy, you know, his mom and dad. Oh, Miss Hit right there, a big Miss Hit once we go to brag on him, so it may be what it comes to. But Braden playing D1 baseball at West Point Army, so hitting 90 miles an hour this year for the baseball team, at least 88, upper 80s, is really bringing in high school baseball. And now Ben is only a freshman or sophomore? Sophomore?
Maybe sophomore, yeah.
So two more years, and he's already our number one singles player and probably going to compete for the regional title for 3 years in a row.
Yeah, he was actually number one singles last year, too, so.
Wow.
Yeah, as a freshman.
Now, he just sliced that one bad, so he might have lost his point, or it may be add in right here for Jackson Flynn. So I'm going to call it add in. I don't know. I'm going to predict the score. So big point right here. See if Jackson can keep it on serve. Ben runs the inside of it. Jackson gets it back. Ben with a nice slice volley approaches the net. Jackson decides to go for the lob. That should be a killer shot for him. And he mishits it. So sometimes you can take too much off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. That's a lot of us struggle with that, actually. You think you're going to kill it, and then, like, mid-decision, you're like, oh, no, I can't. I just got to go for a little bit. And then most of the time you end up, like, hitting it way too light and not actually getting your shot in. But that is, like, something that's, like, when I say, like, that the game's mental, you've really got to be on your game. You have to be in the right mindset. You got to be positive, but you also have to be having quick thinking, quick reflexes, because the sport moves pretty fast.
Question for you. Are you allowed to play tennis in your shades because nobody is wearing them? And I know that sun has to get in your eyes occasionally.
1,000% you're allowed to wear them, but every one of us forget them every single time. you'll see some of them wearing hats, but I don't know how much that helps. I've never really worn a hat. But, yeah, so you actually are allowed to wear glasses, but I forget them every single time that I played. So it's just kind of one of those things you got to keep in your bag or you're never going to remember. You've got to struggle through the pain. I think it's also why they let the guys go first sometimes, because they obviously have hats. You'll see no girls wearing hats, mostly.
Yeah, you know, Ben's got a hat on, but it's backwards, so that's not going to help him at all. Where CJ is wearing his, where the brim can actually protect him a little bit from the sun.
CJ's wearing his to actually protect him, and yeah. Ben's wearing his to look cool.
Yeah, that's a difference, but cool and protection is between the two. So watch this point here between Jackson and Ben. So big high one by Jackson, but way deep. So Morgan's going to go get the ball for the crowd, so she's a team player. So. Oh, I didn't think I was making it, Morgan. You went underhanded. I said, no way, that's going over. I thought it was going to bounce right back on you, but you are a lifesaver for things. So let's watch Ben serve. He's got such a good power serve on this first one, Morgan, if he can keep it in. Jackson had no problem returning that good and deep. And Ben mishits it, hits the net. So, yeah, sometimes you just got to coach yourself, don't you?
Yeah. That's one thing. Tennis is very much like a very independent sport, but it's also one of those ones, like, if you don't listen to your coach, you're definitely going to be screwed, because they know what they're talking about. A lot of the times we don't want to think that they know what they're talking about, but they definitely do. But, yeah, when you're out there, because obviously you can't talk to your coach until you're switching in between games. So it's definitely on you most of the time to get yourself back in that mental state and back in the physical state to start doing better.
Okay, Ben just had two unforced errors in a row, Morgan, so I think he just dropped both games to Jackson Flynn. So Jackson Flynn goes up 2-1 here. So Ben is down a break in set number one. So I know he's a little frustrated, because those were what we call mental mistakes. So, I mean, sometimes, like you said, what's the rules on, and, you know, I know, but I'm going to ask this for the viewers, what's the rules on the coach being able to talk to you during the match? Because obviously it needs to be, I think, in between sets.
Yeah, so, well, you'll actually call those games. So every time that, like, someone serves, it's a game. So when you're on an odd game, so when the games add up to an odd number, so like 2-1, you switch sides of the court. When you're switching, you're allowed to talk to your coach. Parents are not allowed to talk to you at all during your match, which sucks, because I like to listen to my parents, because, like, they feel like they've watched me. obviously my coach watches me a lot. My parents like know what I talk about when I get home and stuff. So yeah, you cannot talk to your parents. You can only talk to your coaches when you're switching sets. They're allowed to like obviously yell at you, but that's not really tennis etiquette to yell during the middle of the match. So yeah, it's definitely something to get used to because you always want to like ask your coach. They can like give you hand signals and like kind of like mouth words and say it to you like if they're behind you, but really not allowed actually.
So a little behind the scenes footage for I hadn't even thought about hand signals or anything else like that. Like calm down, you big dummy. Don't overthink it. You know, bring it down here a little bit. You're fine. You're fine. You're fine. Breathe. You know, it's a big thing we don't talk about enough is the psychology of sports. And sometimes we just beat ourselves because you're so, you know, rough on yourself because you know you can do better. And that's a nice shot by Ben right there to go love 15. But sometimes, you know, you just like you said, you just got to reflect and think back and live in the past. The past is the past. Worry about the next point. But that's easier said than done because sometimes we get so mad at each other out there on the court. You know, you mentioned early on when you were practicing with Coach Atkinson, it sounds like he's only going after the smart players. He finds the ones in pre-cal and statistics and everything else and recruits them to play tennis. So, but you know, saying I see a lot of great student athletes out here, so we got a let here for Jackson Flynn on another serve. But, you know, you're talking about, I was talking to Aiden Geiger a little bit earlier, when you talk about the sport, it looks easy, but it's one of those things where it's hard. And, you know, you talk about this, but I remember when we were first practicing for tennis and I got this big, gorgeous overhead coming up, and I'm like 6 inches behind the net. I'm going to kill this baby. I'm talking about it's going to – I'm going to hit it over the fence. And I swing so hard, Morgan, that I missed the ball completely. And I think I even might even lost my racket, like it was bad for that junior year. And I'm like, oh, my God, that's the most embarrassing thing that can ever happen on the tennis courts. But if you play tennis long enough, I promise at some point in time, your hand-eye coordination is going to fail you, and you're going to miss an easy volley at the net or overhand slam like I did way back in the day. So you got any like big embarrassing moments like I just talked about that you just – well, it was such an easy point that you just whiffed it or too numerous to tell?
Yeah, so back to my first year playing, my junior year, there was a ball. I played singles the end of my junior year, but I only played doubles for my like first half. I played with Katie Taylor. I still play with her. I love her to death.
I saw her the other day. She's really? Working where?
Dairy Mart, but she's also working at the schools and Lowe's.
Lowe's.
She has three different jobs. She's a.
I went and got mulch.
Yes.
And I saw her.
Yes. Okay. Yes. She's.
I was
a
just trying to think.
Hard worker.
I saw her this weekend.
Yes. But yeah. So like you said. One time I was going up and I got these new shoes and I don't, like, guess they were broken in enough. I'm not really sure. I went and I like tried to go for this ball and I forgot that it wasn't volleyball. I went and dove for that ball and I scuffed up my knee so bad because I forgot it was not volleyball. It was absolutely terrible. I mean, I was so embarrassed, really. Also, I'm going to go ahead and speak on you talked about the sports psychology. That is such like an intriguing thing because like you see these like NFL players. I actually heard of this player that I had not played. I think it was the Detroit Lions. The player hasn't played since 2019, but they keep him on the roster so that he can get the help he needs because he has like bipolar and I forget, maybe like depression. And like they keep him on the roster to help him talk through these things. And that just kind of tells you how important it is in sports to have stuff like that. Like, if we had, like, I know obviously we have counselors here, but if we had, like a person here for sports that could talk to you about, like, mind stuff, like, it would really honestly be a lot of help. So, speaking on that, I think it's so intriguing to learn about also. But also, like you talked about the student athletes, one thing about coach is that if you don't go to school that day, you can't go to practice, you can't play in the match. Now, I know, like, in football and a lot of other sports, you can't go to school, like you don't go to school, and the coaches don't pay attention to that. Coach Atkinson checks every single day until 3:15 and makes sure that you are green or yellow on that attendance sheet to make sure that you've at least been at school for part of the day. So that's definitely one thing that he does. Also, if you fail a test or start getting low grades, he pulls you aside and talks to you about it. And that's just one thing. It's like he has so much on his mind that he like really like wants better for you on his team, teammates.
Well, you know, accountability, I think it's a big thing because he's trying to mold you into great young men and women and hold you accountable. And, you know, A lot of times you think parents are going to hold you accountable, but sometimes not so much when they go to check out things. But you're fortunate. You had great parents. Who's this guy to the right of you? Do you know him at all?
I'm not really sure. I think it might be Declan Hayes.
Declan Hayes, huh? Speaking of sports psychology, we may throw Declan on the mic here in a few minutes. Sports psychology. In the school, if you're picking, are you running out Brendan Forrester, James Murray, or John Franklin as your sports psychologist?
I might have to take Foyster on that one. He knows how to calm me down. There was a couple times I about had a mental breakdown in his classroom for sports and school all together, and he really made sure to calm me down. What about you, Declan?
I think Phil Russell is a sports psychologist. You know, he's got a love of the game, and he could talk you through anything. Phil Russell for sure.
I got to get back to the lights.
Okay. It's good to see you, man. Good to see you. So the one and only Declan Hayes right here. Good to see you, my man. Stop by sometime. Hey,
go ahead. Just going to say, go Maroons and go Cats.
I love it. Hey, Maroon Sports Awards, we're still working on the date, but once we know them, we'd love to have our former alumni to come back in if you guys want to join in on the MSAs on year number two. So we don't have our date set, but we're working on all the different categories and the nominees, and we'll probably do a video sometime for the fans to watch, for the viewers to say, here are the nominees for this year, and then you know, you guys can't vote because you're out of school now, but you can certainly see the nominees.
Yeah, I got locked out of that email a long time ago.
All right, Declan, be safe going back. So, how long has this relationship been going on?
A year and a half on Sunday.
Okay, well, you've got a great man. So, I'm not going to lie. If I didn't like him, I wouldn't say it. But he is one of those that the cream of the crop. So, he's in the top probably 2-3% to come out of PC. So.
Yeah, I always told myself, actually there's a video, do you know, Elizabeth Dalton, obviously. Mm-hmm. She has a video of me saying that I'm never going to date anyone from this school. And she sent it to me the other day. It was really humbling because I was like, there's no one good in this school. Everyone's immature, but honestly it was just the age, I guess, but I'm so lucky that I found him.
Well, that's a good story. So, yeah, a year and a half right here. So, what we got, well, I don't see the score changed over. It says 2-1.
Yeah, I believe they're on their fifth.
Fifth
so
game.
After this.
Do you know if Ben broke or if he's now 3-1 or if it's 2-2?
I've been watching, but I don't pay attention that much.
Okay, so you and I will have to. So, fans, we'll watch a couple more games here. Good little slice volley, long shot by Jackson Flynn, so that goes out. So, whenever Jackson messes up, he's got the head rub, what he's got going on for things. So, speaking of Foyster, our man would be here today, and he's going to be jealous knowing I'm right beside you for my wingman today. So, but he's got sick on us. So he actually missed school on Friday and today, and he never misses school.
Yeah.
So if you know anything about Brandon Foyster, it's weird because I pulled in today and like Monday, so about like my early day for the week, and I got here about 6:30 today, but he had already been here for 30 minutes or an hour had he been at school.
Right.
You know, so when his vehicle's not here, I know he's not. I beat him in one time last year, Morgan. I come in at 5:30 one morning, and I beat him. So that's the only time I beat him to school all of last year was that day I come in at 5:30. All right, so talk about our matches. Looks like we got CJ just 1-0 over here. He's on court two.
I don't think they switched it.
Yeah,
unless that first game was real long, I don't think they switched the score when they switched, which is a lot of times, like you honestly kind of forget to do that most times.
Well, I'm going to give you the mic here in a minute and go get the fans a score update on all the other courts because, as you know, in tennis today, they should be playing, I think it's 4 doubles matches and 3 singles matches, or is it 2 and 3? Oh, Ben fell down. So that's going to be a good Jackson Flynn nominee right here. So Ben don't want to see that one on Maroon Sports Network.
I think we got that.
we got it on camera. What I'm saying is it happens to us all. But when I miss the overhead volley, there's no camera. There's no technology. Nobody can prove it. If I hadn't told you, nobody would know unless my high school buddies remembered it way back when. But so Jackson mishits that one a little bit. So good serve by Ben looking at his racket.
It looks like CJ's up 2-1. This is a long set right here.
So, you know, talking about the cream of the crop, though, Toby Durham does such a good job. You know his daughter coming through here, and she just got signed for the Governor's School of Arts. So that's a big one for
Princess.
And Prom Princess. So big weekend for her with things. So we may be a great choir singer. So, but Toby's such a good coach, and these are two of the top programs in the 12th region as far as being hit it out of bounds right here, so a little bit wide here. So Mark Flynn Jr. is coming over to get the ball. Amy Flynn Jr. is picking it up and ready to go. So Jackson Flynn throws it back over, the big lefty. So, you know, saying that, him and is it Jesselyn? What's his sister's twin sister's name? Jessie is what I call her. Basketball player. So, great athletes in the family, though, so for them to be twins in here. And I think, are they juniors
yeah,
or seniors?
I believe they're juniors.
I think they're juniors as well. So I think there's a year behind things. Morgan, we got some serious heat going over here, so you may get a tan today with things, because
well,
I know my head's going to get burned up.
Oh,
you got a little bit of shade from the utility.
I
don't need the sun. So if we're going to protect anybody, we're going to protect you today. Okay. So we've got some things. Okay, looks like we're ready to switch sides. Or is it 2-2 and they're just taking a break before? Usually you don't get a drink.
No,
hello, and
they won't break, so.
It should be either. It's going to be 3-2 one way or the other, because I'm pretty sure Ben won that game.
Yeah.
So we'll see. Fans, here in just a minute, we'll go over to CJ Heist's match, because we got to get a little bit of everybody. Hopefully camera 2 will come up here before too much longer, because I'd love to be able to switch camera views back and forth. But we need a bigger operating crew than you and I and Aiden to pull this thing off. And speaking of, I don't know where Aiden's at, so right now it's you and I and the world out here for things. So we got a stationary camera on court number
one. Yeah, so he's down one four.
Really?
Ben is, yeah.
Ben Hampton.
So he's talking to Alfie. He's got the pro over there.
Okay. Alfie's working. I mean, no notice things right now. I just noticed some mishits, some things that aren't being mentally there right now with things, because, you know, a lot of times you're only as good as your last match is what they're going to say for things. And this match over here with CJ is a really good match, too. I'm afraid all four matches are going to be really good. There's the famous Derry Burkett walking over, so I know he's going to watch Ben Webb here a little bit later, his grandson, play for things. And Ben may be playing right now. Ben is he? Over on court number four, number one doubles.
Yeah,
let me pull this up. Let me give you the mic for just a second. I'll pull up the matchups.
Yeah, so it looks like Ben is talking to Alfie to kind of get back in the rhythm of things. One thing about tennis, though, for sure, is when you're in your match and you always tell yourself, like, going into it, well, there's no way I'll lose because you have so many opportunities. But somehow it always just, like, not always, but often happens to where you get down by three sets and you don't really know what to do, so you got to kind of talk it out with your coach and get back in the rhythm of things. So I kind of feel like Ben's going to come back here, and I don't even think it's Flynn doing anything too special. It's honestly just Ben trying to do too much almost. So he's trying to get back into his rhythm right here, and we got second serve for Flynn, and it's 0-15. And that's out on Ben, so looks like he's down.
You know, I'm watching match number 2 over here, and we got CJ Heist against Aaron Doan is the name of the guy he's playing. But Aaron has got a solid game going over right here, because right now I'm a little bit worried on this men's match, because we're 8-0 coming in, and the girls are 9-0. And I don't know Southwestern's record, but right now we are down in one and two singles right now. So that one's deep for Jackson Flynn, so he called it out before he hit it. So you can't lose. I don't feel like a lot of times you're one and two singles and come back here. You know, a lot of times I need to ask coach, because sometimes you're going to play pro sets. Sometimes you're going to play best 2 out of 3 sets. Sometimes you're just playing that one pro set to 8. But today, with it being a split match like this, Aaron Doan was out for CJ here. So most of the time it's going to be two out of three sets to 6.
It just kind of depends, like, really how many players you have. So, like, or this is a hometown match, they'll probably do that, the 3-2. No, I forget what the actual, like, layout of it, but they'll do the one where they'll try to get as many in as they can. If they're at an away match, they'll usually just do, like, 2-2 or something, and they'll do exhibition matches. But I think this is going to be the one where they try to get everyone in and actually count it towards the record. I wish I could remember that number. I'm really not for sure. Oh, that was out.
It's 2 sets out of 3 is what it should be here. So we need to come out here for Jackson Flynn. But it's a big difference when you got a crosstown rival and you can start your match at 4 o'clock.
Yeah.
You're not waiting until 5 o'clock for the bus to get here.
Yeah, I don't like that. I feel rushed.
You feel rushed?
Uh-huh.
But like we talked earlier, just a shortage of courts, and you're trying to get a boys and girls game in. So good shot right there by Ben. Jackson got it back. So what's Ben going to do here? Kills it. Jackson Flynn gets it back. But, oh, my gosh, it's in. So we're able to recover this point. So now he's got
good,
Ben.
Good, wide
and out. So, man, that's a good recovery by Jackson Flynn right there, because I thought Ben was in control of that. So set number one appears to be all Jackson Flynn right here for just a second. So here we go. Jackson, the big lefty, up to serve.
You know, when you're actually playing when you're actually playing against a lefty, you don't really notice they're a lefty until, like, someone says something. You don't ever notice until you start realizing that their forehand is the same side as your forehand, so it's kind of odd. Because, like, say, like me, my backhand's stronger, so if I was a lefty, my backhand would be going way stronger to the other guy's backhand, which is great because it's kind of what's what you want. You want to go to their weaker side.
Ben just had a really nice slice shot right then for a winner, so I don't know what the score of the game is, but that was a nice shot by Ben Hampton. Deep shot here by Jackson Flynn, so serve number two coming up.
Nice shot, CJ. Went right over the net. I mean, it, like, slow motion.
Oh, hit it out. That was deep by about 6 inches. Ben is a little flustered right here. All right, we couldn't ask for any prettier day at all. So here on CJ's court.
That's one thing. It's totally different. Like, coming from volleyball, you got a line judge. You got two line judges, a down ref and an up ref. So you got four people watching one court, seeing what's in, what's out, doubles, no doubles. I mean, you've got stepping over the line. You've got the ball hitting on the line, whatever. When it comes to tennis, I'm telling you, it's an independent sport. It is all on you. You call every shot. You call every ball. It's really on you how your game goes. Now, one thing about Coach Atkinson is that he will, if he sees something, and, like, obviously you're not going to be 100%. You're going to miss some shots. You're going to think some are out and they're actually in. You're going to think some are in and they're actually out. But one thing about Coach is that he does not allow, like, if we're in practice and one of us calls something out, he makes us go, like, show him where that ball was and, like, make sure, because he does not condone cheating. And when other teams do, I mean, there's a lot of times you play against people that do cheat and coaches don't know nothing about it. But our coach, there's so many matches where I'm like, Coach, these people are ticking me off. They're lying on my name, saying, oh, these balls are out. And I know they're not out. He's like, I know, but we've nothing we can do about it. I'm like, I'm feisty. I want to do something about it. And you know what he tells me to do? Shut my pie hole. That's what he tells me to do. So I'm not used to that. I like to tell somebody if they're doing wrong. I mean, that's the right thing to do, isn't it?
Now, when I played tennis, maybe things were different, but I remember one match in particular. We had a match that we were playing. I think it was South Oral at the time. And they were calling some balls out that I thought were in. And, you know, when it's on the baseline, it's tough looking for the other side. It truly is. But when you miss four calls out of four that you think are in and all four are out, you know, the odds are maybe a little skewed there in one way or the other. We could always call in somebody to come and actually line judge the match if you had a dispute.
Yes.
Between the two.
Yeah.
Parties.
Yeah, that's also how it works. So our coach, he doesn't really like to do that, but yes, so, like, if you're having trouble and it's obvious, like, so obvious that something's going on, they'll bring out each of the coaches or each of the assistant coaches to come out and watch the lines for you just for a set or even just for a game and just kind of see what's going on. And then if there's no, like, missed calls, then it's obvious that they were just doing it because they didn't think no one was watching. So, yeah, that's something that you can do for sure. Also, looks like we got a principal over there. Is that correct? Am I seeing right?
Yes.
And he used to play tennis too, didn't he?
He used to be the coach.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Yeah. So we've got I know we got a lot of teachers that play. I mean, we got Atkinson, we've got Principal, we got Cook, we got you, we've got Grubbs.
DeBoard.
We've got a deep lineup. And I remember saying before I graduated we were gonna play, and there was a time that I played Grubbs actually. We got Grubbs and Coach out here to play. And then we try to get something else together. So maybe we'll have to do that sometime soon.
That sounds like a deal. I'd be happy to play with you sometime. I play about once a year, Morgan. So we'll see how much it comes back.
That'll be your once a year.
It'll be my once a year. We'll come back. But now I do need to pick up pickleball. I need a new sport for things. So if I go to Google and Amazon, and I go to Amazon, $40-$50 can get me into the game?
Oh, cheaper than that. I mean, for a starter paddle, my starter paddle was $89, which doesn't got to be that expensive. But I did buy it off somebody. And they told me it was a really good racket. I got it for a little bit cheaper than that, but it is like a $90, like, value racket. But you can get a cheaper one. I mean, you can get them at Walmart for $15, $20. But honestly, a $50 paddle would do really good for your first time playing. I like to have a textured paddle. Don't get a smooth paddle. You can't put no spin on the ball if you know how to do that.
Okay. Well, you know, speaking about that, you know, talking about this with fans and things, I remember when I first started tennis, Morgan, I went to Walmart and I got a Wilson.
Yep.
Got a Wilson racket, paid about $15 for it back in the late 1980s. And the difference in rackets, though, is amazing, and you don't realize it until you buy up and pay for it. So it's like I went from a Wilson to a Prince to a Head, and the Head was my favorite racket that I had, and that was Andre Agassi back in the day, played with Head. And so I still got that racket, believe it or not. It's 30-some years old, and that's one I'll play with against you because I've never bought anything new since then. I know the technology is so much better than it was in 1990, but the difference between the Wilson and the Prince is a good racket too, so I'm not knocking Prince, but the difference between the Wilson and the Head was amazing, and the ball control and the speed.
Yeah, so that's one thing though, when you're going to buy your rackets, it's really all in the strings. You can have whatever racket, but I get mine restrung. And
you might have to talk while I go switch the camera over.
Yeah,
the camera.
Yeah. So one thing about having like different rackets is it's the stringing that really matters. You can get the bounce on them. You can get the, but also the size. I have a bigger racket. Yeah. You gotta have. I like to have a bigger racket. Obviously, as I was starting out, and I got a wider one, and it kind of helped me like not miss the ball as much. But that's something that for sure you gotta do. But looks over here on court one, looks like Ben Hampton is down 2-5. So I believe first and second seeds go to eight, pros up to eight, but we'll see. It might be six, so I could be mistaken on that. So if it's six, then Ben is only has like no losses left. He's gonna have to win the rest of these. But if CJ over here looks like he's up 4-1, so that's good for this side. Both players are playing phenomenal though. I've watched, and it like every time I look, it looks like one or the other is winning the point, but I guess the way it adds up, CJ's winning most of them and pulling them out, so that's good. But here comes Flynn back and Ben back, so we'll see if they're going to start getting going over here. And Alvy looks like he's giving him a good talking to, so maybe that'll bring him back into the game over here. And CJ looks like he won that point, and CJ's got served, so we'll see if these go to eight, if it's supposed to be eight or six. We'll see here. But Flynn serving his first serve on the eighth game. All right, go ahead. Looks like Ben had lost that last point. Now they're on left 15 for PC. To the left.
One more.
Trying to get this angle set up for you all here. That should be good right there. Yeah, that's good, yeah. So now it looks like we're on the court we've been talking about all day here. We've got CJ and I think his name is Aaron. Over here on court one, back to it. Ben's doing a little slice here. And you just got that back. Ooh, rally the net. Good. Good point by Ben Hampton over there on court one. I was telling him, I've been looking at court two, and you think, like, every time you look, CJ's winning a point. Is his name Aaron, correct? Southwestern?
Yes, Aaron,
yeah. So Aaron's winning a point. CJ's winning a point every time you look, but it just looks like CJ's pulling out the games.
Yes. Yeah, I noticed too. It looked so even when I looked at the match, and I was surprised when I went and saw CJ go up 4-1 right here. But man, CJ's got some solid strokes. Got the big serve that just loops in. Now that one went out of bounds a little long on that one. But watch his second serve. It's windy right here on us right now, but he's going to kick it right in there, and boom, perfect, good and deep. Look at that forehand. Wow, that was smoke. I don't know.
I think he knows it's on film.
I don't know if Mr. Murray could handle that one or not. I mean. That one might have got me right there for things. Ben going with the deep lob and just out. Uh-oh, you got to save the day again, Morgan. You're the hero again. Another ball jumps over the fence here. So CJ's up 4-1 and serving, but a big, big return here from Doan for the winner. So I don't know the score of the game yet, but we'll get to it here in a second. So Mr. CJ Heist. Now, I don't know. I need to ask Coach what grade CJ's in. Eighth grade, freshman?
Eighth grade.
Eighth
last
grade.
Year was, well, I think last year was his first year, and he was in seventh. So, wow. Yeah, because you can't play until you're in seventh grade. And so he was in seventh grade last year. That was his first year. I believe he's in eighth grade now. But, yeah, he is phenomenal for an eighth grader. And it must just run in their genes because you've got Savannah that's amazing too, and then their younger sister
Caroline,
yeah, she's great too. But they also, their parents having them out here practicing late at night too, and that's what it takes sometimes.
I've seen them on the court a few times or two when I come in through school. Now it looks like a whole lot like here. Like CJ has really like grown taller and lankier in the past year, and I know that helps in tennis with this big serve. But we'll miss hit by Doan here, went way to the left. We've all done that before though. CJ, man, he's going to be one of those that's going to be regional champ before it's all over with, too.
Yeah, for sure, because obviously him and Ben and Aiden are all pretty. One thing I will say, when you're watching the two, you can definitely tell Ben's a little bit older. You can tell that he like, doesn't try to do as many crazy shots. Now, when I played with CJ last year, him and Aiden kind of would go for every big shot. They didn't really care about what was going to get them the point. They wanted to look cool. They were doing tweeners and they were doing all these cool shots to try to like do like better than the other guy, but really it just kind of lost them the game most times. But one thing that I've kind of seen CJ and I watching him today is that he's not trying to do them big shots. He's just trying to win. He's not trying to show off. And so, but there's definitely a maturity when you're getting older, watching these matches and playing, you really can notice how much players can mature. Like, you know, obviously people can mature in their personalities and stuff, but as a player you also mature a lot by knowing, okay, I don't need to do these big shots. I really need to keep it in, especially if you're down. Like right now in Ben's situation, he's doing a lot of slicing and a lot of lobs because he's not trying to lose this point, because obviously he wants to win this match.
Well, Jackson just brought in the hammer right here, brought in another hammer. Look at Ben just getting it back casually. So two big shots. We're talking about court one, fans. I know you can't see it.
Yeah,
so big win by Ben. So CJ's back on serve here. So CJ with a nice kick right down the baseline and a little bit of a miss hit here by Doan. So it goes wide left. So CJ's coming back up. And I'd say you probably can on the near side, I would say. But, you know, in the match, though, a lot of times, and you know being out there being a tennis player, you zone everything out.
Yeah.
You don't hear any. You're focused on that right there.
Yeah.
So I would be surprised if he could, because it'd take a focus. Got a big forehand, but just goes into the net. So we get to see Mr. Jackson Flynn run over through here again, so he gets to listen to us.
Looks like Aaron's kind of the young player too, just like kind of like from his looks. I'm not sure.
He does. I'll agree with you.
He looks like he looks like he'd be a mature player, but like physically, I believe that he's a little bit younger.
I would.
And you know what I wish they would do? I wish that they would put, tennis on KHSAA on.
Who can we call to contact about that? Because I'd like to see the scoreboard too, the KHSAA scoreboard.
Scoreboard, yeah.
Yep.
I would love, because obviously it's a little bit hard to like keep track of, but they could at least put 5-2-0,
yes,
whatever, you know.
Yes.
Like, and then because I love to have the rosters when I'm watching any game. I want to know who's out there playing, you know. I want to know who, like, if I'm like, oh, they're good, I'm going to see them go D1 or D2, you know. But I can't do that with tennis. I never know who I'm playing because I can never find their names on these lists. Like, they got field hockey on there. What about tennis? Come on now.
All right, Julian Tackett, that's the commissioner of KHSAA. Maroon Sports Network is petitioning that we get all sports put on the app because it's something easy to do, and we just tennis, win 4-3, 5-2, 6-1, whatever it may be.
And comments, questions, and suggestions to this email.
All right.
But I'm about to call in the score and be like, yeah, you don't got us on there. You can't put us in there.
And, you know, what a great, great couple of years for Maroon Sports. And I'm telling you, anything from archery to baseball to, you know, men's and women's basketball to, you know, cheerleading to volleyball to, I mean, the list goes on and on and on women's archery winning everything.
Yeah.
So it's fine times here. And then we're getting a brand new building over there by Northern Middle School,
yeah,
that health and wellness
that,
building.
Yeah.
So hopefully that will be another intramural gym. I think that's going to be for faculty and staff, but I'm hoping they let the gym be used as a fill-over gym is my hope.
So are they building another one, or is it the one they already have put up down there?
That one they got put up, but they also did one on the south end. So they got a south and a north end for wellness.
I remember when I was – it was our last couple weeks, and Ellen and Allie Sexton, they interned at some, like, architect place, and they were putting together plans for that building. It's pretty cool to kind of see it come to life.
That is super cool. I didn't know that. And I love a little green bean. That was such a good nickname in volleyball. And have you seen – and we've got some great plays of the year this year. We're doing a double match tonight.
Are we playing Rock?
The girls are playing Rock. The boys are playing Southwestern.
So I'm guessing in the beginning of the season, the girls, Pulaski played girls Southwestern already?
I assume so, Morgan. I don't know. I didn't ask Coach the rationale behind it.
I've never seen this happen. Yeah. Never. I mean, we've done like doubleheaders, but we've played men's and women's. But it's usually with teams that only have a couple qualifying matches, we don't really do a lot with. Like teams that only have like six players, we'll just do the 3-2 set.
I think we need more benches and seating here because we're going to have a lot of fans out there just standing up.
We had no benches last year. How about that? I came out here for my first match. It was a couple weeks ago. I came out here and watched PC play against Somerset Christian. They had bleachers. When I was here, we had one little skinny bench, and we had to stand up the entire game or sit on that ground. And so I'm glad to see it improving. I really am. I'm glad that they're doing other things for tennis because tennis really does get the short end of the stick a lot of times. But, they got bleachers out here.
Maybe that's called the Morgan effect, that they just went ahead and said, okay, you know, maybe it's time to start improving things now that she's moved on and she's an advocate for the tennis team and it's time to get these. But I'm like you, Morgan. I've never seen two schools on the same night come, because generally you'll have a boys and a girls team and you'll just play each other on the same night. And so we'll have to ask Coach A what the rationale behind this was. But
see, I know Somerset Christian does that often, but they don't have courts. So when they have to use our courts, they have to get as much as they can in, so that they'll usually do two teams like we're doing right now.
Okay. Ben is really missing that slice shot right now, and I know we're watching court two instead of court number one, but Ben is still making some mistakes, and first serve's not coming in, and it's one of those.
He did win a game, though, because Flynn, off the switch, Flynn served that first game, so unless they're going to eight. Is it opposed to eight or six today, do you know?
I don't know. That's a good question.
Yeah, I don't want to ask.
Oh, my gosh. Missed a six-incher and hit it in the net. So, Ben has to be so frustrated right now. So, we'll go back and focus here a little bit on court number two. So, C.J. Heist up 5-1. I think he won the last game, Morgan. So, here we go. But this kid for Southwestern's a really good tennis player.
Yeah, he is. I mean, C.J.'s just tough competition, really, for anybody. I mean, I played him one time, and I thought I was about to smother. I think I won maybe two games against him. It's like his serve.
He gets.
I barely can return his serve. That's one thing.
He gets really, really low and gets that forehand back super early and gets the racket back. So the preparation is immense. So I can see a lot of these kids here playing at the next level for PC. And, I mean, if you're an eighth grader and you've already got that much game, I mean, I can only imagine the sky's the limit for how much he can improve between now and 4 years from now.
Absolutely. How did you find out his name? Yeah.
Coach sent me the roster.
Oh, good.
So,
good.
Yeah, I've got text messages on here. So, I wish we could get a little doubles action on here, but I don't know if we'll be able to work it in or not. What a serve right there. Did you see that one by Dolan?
That was great.
That brought a little bit of heat right there.
Those ones that go right down the middle are often the hardest because you're all, like, it's coming right at you. So, you got not even a second to determine if you want to do a forehand or if you want to do a backhand. I like them when they're on the line because then, if I see a player that's serving to me, right on that middle line, my backhand's my strongest, so I'm going to get to the side of it, and I'm going to hit that, you know? Or if it's going, like, one way or the other, and then they're going to see me standing on one side, and they're going to start to the complete opposite and screw me over, but it happens.
Well, here's a weird coincidence. You and I are probably in the minority. I always like my backhand better, too.
Yeah.
So I love – but I was a two-hand backhand person. Are you a two or a one?
Two. Two-hand backhand, but I can also do lefty forehand. Coach told me to not do that, but I can't. Like, there's a lot of balls. Like, I had a save, and I could easily save them, but I couldn't play my best game with doing a one-hand backhand.
Have we got any players out there, speaking of, that hit a forehand from both sides?
I don't think so. I mean, obviously, I think any player can do it, but none that are skilled enough at both sides to be able to do so.
Yeah, that would
Coach
be.
Coach doesn't really condone that. He doesn't like it.
Yeah, I'd rather stick on the backhand. So, it looks like CJ just broke. So, let's see if this is 6-1 right here. I think it may be, Morgan. But they may be playing to 8.
They're playing to 8, yeah, because Flynn's up 6-3.
Okay, so on court number one, Jackson Flynn is up 6-3 on our man, Ben Hampton.
Yeah, also what I've noticed is that Ben is going 1-1 with him. So, there was obviously a switch where – Flynn had won two of the games, but now Ben looks like he's letting Flynn have one and he's taking one, but now he needs to really step up his game and take both of them.
I'm looking over here at two doubles, Morgan. It's 6-5 in that two doubles match. So, man, that would be a good one if I had the second camera up and running. So I'm going to have to apologize to her fans for not having multiple cameras that we can go back and forth to here.
You can almost see that match, though, in this angle.
You could catch, part of two doubles. One doubles, I need to walk down there and look at the score for us to give us an update on one doubles down there. So I may run down there real quick and give us a score update.
Do you know who that is playing with?
I do. Here, I'll give you the mic and I'll look.
Because I'm not sure if I'm really familiar with who's playing with Webb right now, but it looks like we got Tackett and Baird, Camden and John David on court three. Looks like they're ahead by one, so that's good. And they do not have serve. Actually, take that back. They do have serve.
Aiden Webb and Aiden Chang.
That's not Aiden. I just saw Aiden walk past me up here. That ain't Aiden. It looks like I think I played with him last year. I don't remember his name. Let's see. No, it's not Aiden.
It's Camden Tackett, John David Baird, or Isaac Murray and Winston Cook?
That's Winston Cook.
They've already got the match over, and they're starting three doubles down there then.
Winston Cook.
Because I promised one doubles was there. So three doubles is there now.
I was wondering if it was Cook. You know why? He has that curly hair just like Gavin. I was like, that looks like a Cook, but I don't want to say wrong.
They're going to play Chandler. What's that, Woke or Wolf? Chandler Wolf and Jonathan.
Chandler Woley.
Goldman. And then court number two right now you've got out there. You got Camden Tackett and John David.
Yeah.
Versus Chris Brown and Jackson Wright is match number two here. So I need to figure out who won one doubles.
Yeah. Aiden looked pretty happy walking back here to get food. Maybe it was because of the food or maybe because he won. We're not sure.
Him a winner then.
Yeah. Either way, he's a winner. But one thing I had noticed over here talking about these doubles matches is that John David started out last year, and he has improved a ton. He's playing with Camden, if that tells you anything. Camden was our number three singles. Took over Kaysen's spot when Kaysen didn't play my senior year. Yeah.
Did you see that?
That was a good hit right there. Mm-hmm. And one thing I'll tell you, I have not bought new tennis shoes since my first ever match, and they're flat on the bottom because you slide around so much on this ground and you're wearing them out. I have got to get a new pair because I'll tell you, I have no traction in them shoes left anymore.
Okay, where are those old shoes whenever we play against each other? I want no traction going up there.
Hey, I call them my lucky shoes even though I lose a lot in them.
All right.
I'm getting the same pair, just different color. Brand new.
So CJ, a little miss hit here by Aaron Doan. So CJ's in firm control at 6-1.
Hey,
but
Aiden, did you win your match?
Oh, no, we lost one doubles. See what the score of one doubles was, and we'll report it.
Hey, what was the score? It was close.
Okay, Southwestern wins one doubles, 8-5. They are leading one singles. We are leading two singles, and we are leading two doubles. So this is going to be close and coming right down to the wire.
If we get two and three doubles to win, and then I think CJ is going to win. Well, not with that hit, but he'll win. I think if we can get those three to win, even if we win the other two, we still win 3-2, and we'll be up 10-0 on the season.
Yeah, that may be a big match when it comes down to your three singles match, and you got Winston Cook and Isaac Murray, both middle schoolers, playing number three doubles. I mean, that could be the qualifying match of the day to see who wins between Southwestern and PC. So we need to figure out how to get a camera down there eventually right here, but we'll keep watching. Aiden, we any closer to that thing being charged up and ready to go? Our man Aiden Geiger's working on getting a camera charged for us so we can get a little doubles action. Okay, see if you can find a break time that you can put it over there, Aiden, whenever you're walking. Just make sure they're not
honestly
serving.
Right now, because, number three's off court,
Okay, so perfect time. Morgan's helping him move in right here. So let's see if we can root our man CJ on right here to come to the bottom line. You're talking about all the Heiss family earlier between Savannah and CJ. And I love watching Caroline play basketball, man. She seems like she's a little go-getter that she's out there. So good serve right here by Aaron. Great backhand. CJ, look at this, man. CJ is solid.
I love watching his forehand.
Yes.
Like, that's one thing about me. I always struggle with my forehand. But now, I feel like I can kind of do those upper shots, but there's no way I could hit a ball that hard with that much control. it takes a lot of skill.
You need to have some good top spin on it. You need to be able to make sure it rises and drops at the same time. Okay. You know what I noticed about pickleball, I think I would like, it's a lot of quick reflexes. Mm-hmm. Like it's bang, 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 bang.
Yeah,
it's not a lot of it. It even bounces a lot of times.
Absolutely.
And so I'll just have to learn the rules about being in the kitchen and all that. Going to save us again, Morgan. Get another ball. All right, so Jackson Flynn lobs one, hits it out right here. So we're in a big battle right here at number one singles. And this could go for seeding, you know. You talk about that. All these matches factor into when the coaches meet to seed the players at the end of the year. So it's up. All right. Morgan's going to switch over here. We should be in control of two singles. Okay, you got it back on CJ's, right? Okay, we'll finish out CJ's match, then we'll go over to doubles. So that one's just a little bit long. I can tell by CJ's reaction a lot of times. It looks like we got the Rock Castle Lady Rockets coming to use the quarters to get ready for the game. Morgan, we got some food we got to eat here in a few minutes. Me, you, and Aiden's got to maybe say, folks, no sound. We're in a short. Ben just missed overhead, and he's really frustrated right now.
Over, we'd probably be able to.
I think they're going to do boys JV.
Okay.
But like you said, we
see, that
no offense, boys JV, but we can eat.
Well, I think that surprised me that they're going to do JV, though, because usually if you're doing a double match, you don't really focus on JV.
That is true. So I don't know coach's thoughts here.
There's
but
really no JV. It's really just exhibition matches. They don't count, so I'm not really sure why they would do exhibition when they got a whole other match to play.
Okay, CJ, they're not change that score, or is this match over with? I'm going to say it's over. 8-1, CJ.
Okay.
If it is, I need to move the camera.
Yeah,
are we over here?
Yeah. And also, this game over here, they just switched, so does that mean that Ben gets 4-7?
They should have changed the score, shouldn't they?
I'm telling you, they don't. You don't focus on score when you're playing. You got it in your head. You don't care about other people's sake. You're just playing for like playing to win. There you go.
Oh, no. Yes. Okay, fans. I'm going to let Morgan here have the mic, and I'm going to go sneak back over here. Morgan, let me know when we get in view for court number one.
All right, we're going to switch it back over here to Ben and Flynn. Well, maybe they're not done, Murray. Yeah. Ben is on his – well – receiving a second serve. That was an easy lob. Let's see what he does with it. Looks like Flynn's getting a little tired. Let's see if Ben can keep his momentum going. It's a good, yeah, Flynn ain't moving much. Maybe he's trying to trick up Ben's game plan because he knows Ben likes to hit a little hard.
You're good.
Nope. Yep. All right. Got you back on court one. James Murray with the etiquette there. All right. Here's Ben receiving his first serve. Oh, he called that out. So, good return, though. All right, Ben, there you go. Nice shot. That was Ben with the put down. That was an amazing shot. I think he might be up 30-15. I could be wrong. I think it's at 30-15 right now, though. That'll be good. I think he's either at 5. It's either 4-7 or 5-6. So, either one, he's getting back up there. But he keeps giving him one. So, but I was telling him, looks like Flynn's out there getting a little tired. He's not moving much. Maybe it's trying to throw Ben off. But maybe he's actually just really getting tired and wearing him down.
Oh, nice half volley right there.
Nice
by Ben.
Shot,
nice
Ben.
Winner right there. So, Jackson's a little frustrated right there on the movement. But, Ben is, I thought he was walking over toward the scorecard, but have we got a double break point right now, or are they talking about the match? I think they're trying to discuss.
They're trying to discuss what the score is.
Yeah.
Have you seen those things that go on your racket and you can, like, slide up the score to keep track? I feel like I forget to do it, but it keeps, like, you, like, sticking.
Look
on
here, Morgan, he's broke Jackson Flynn because he's taking the serve. So that's big.
Okay, good, yeah.
So I do know that Ben served first in the match because we started the match out with that. So right now it could be.
So it's either 4-7 or 6 saw, right?
This should be an odd game, so this should be 5-7, I would imagine. 5-7 or 6-6?
Nice shot.
Because they didn't change the score last time.
Yeah, so what I'm saying, yeah, it could, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know what to call it, but it should be 12 games played. So it's either 5-7 or 6-6. Change the score next time, Ben Hampton, so well, the viewers will know up here because we can only go by the score over here on the column. So we don't want to talk to him right here, but hopefully we'll know after this service game what the score is, fans. But big match right here as far as today. What a serve. Woof. Don't know. I didn't hear Jackson say anything. Yes, it was. He's switching sides. Nice ace, Ben Hampton. Maybe it takes him being a little bit frustrated right here, but that was unreturnable for a lot of high school players. So second serve right here for Ben Hampton. Ben gets it in. Jackson.
Come on, Ben.
Oh, good. Jackson under hits it.
All right, so it should be
30 love.
Unless he goes back to add.
Should be going to the deuce court.
Yeah,
all right, here we go, fans. Beautiful day. We're ready to get through some matches right here so Morgan and I can get some food.
He's in the add-in court, so that means he's 30 left. Yeah.
30 left.
Yeah. He went to the deuce court.
Boom, what a serve again.
Nice serve.
Wow, Ben Hampton, 40 love.
He's got it in him right there. I think he's really stepping up.
Okay, where's Jackson walking to right now? It should be 40 love, right, so I don't know where Jackson's. No, we were wrong about the score. So we were wrong all along. Now it's 6-5. So they were keeping up with the score. So it was 6-4. So that made it 6-5.
But he only moved it up once.
He moved it up two. It was 3-6 when he walked over
there.
And Jackson moved it up.
Look at him go. Look at Bingo. He's coming back. He talked to, like Coach tried to talk to him, and he ain't going to go over there, is he?
Well, one thing he's got to do right here, you know, you're still, that was big to hold your own serve, but you're still down a break. So unless he can get this break from Jackson, Jackson can serve it out because all they got to do is trade points the rest of the game.
But I think, I really do think Flynn's getting tired. I was watching him and it doesn't look like he wasn't really hitting any long shots. He was kind of walking to the ball. So if Ben can get him to on his opposite side, I think that'll really help.
Am I crazy?
Oh, nice.
Am I a crazy man here, or is your coach like in a full jacket/sweatshirt and shades, like a Tom Cruise look?
No, he for sure is in this 82 degree weather. Don't ask me what he's doing. No, for sure. I really do not understand.
He's burning me up. Okay.
Maybe he's trying to keep the sun off of him.
But he's over here coaching right now, so he's showing him the stance. He's showing him how to open up. You know, speaking of things too, Morgan, we didn't talk about the what a shot right over here on court number two, so fans can see it. I wish we could switch back camera to camera right there as we got dead periods in
for the
breaks. Yes. That would be nice, wouldn't it? All the way out here to be able to do it. But your coach is actually one of those coaches that can actually not only coach the game, but he plays the game.
He's
a dang good tennis player.
He sure is, yeah. When we were speaking about rackets earlier, I came into my very first practice with one of those Wilson's rackets you were talking about, $20 racket from Walmart. And he let me use his, and I fell in love with his. Well, I ended up buying a different one that I love, but my next racket will be Coach Atkinson's racket. I love it. I absolutely love it. The stringing on it's amazing. Size of it's perfect. But, yeah, he when he goes out there and plays, he plays, and he is a hard player to beat. I don't know if he's scared to play me or what, but he don't ever put us against each other when we're playing. He don't ever put us on the same team either in our league.
Okay, Coach, so you've heard that, so – it's time for you to get a new racket. It's time for you to sell your old one to Morgan, Keith, or donate it either one. She'll take donations.
I'll take a donation.
But, you know, you could give your former player a discount and alumni, and she's here calling the game for free.
He don't even use that racket anymore. Oh. It's just sitting in his bag going to rot. I don't want that thing. I might just go steal it out of his bag.
Somebody can put it to good use, Coach. It's like the old clothes that you take to Goodwill. Now, Ben Way overhit that one.
Yeah, I think Ben's problem is that he usually has a really good topspin. Today it doesn't look like he spent too much topspin on it. He's kind of just hitting them all out.
I think what I've noticed so far, and I may be wrong, I think Ben likes power more, so he can answer power with power. And where Jackson's just getting them back over, and a lot of times it's just softly hitting them over, he can't control the speed of the return, and he's hitting them deep. So So I may be wrong in that one, but that seems like to me he'd rather have pace.
Yeah. Yeah, kind of like what we were talking about earlier. Like CJ, he very much calms down the game now. He, instead of letting them all go and, like, trying to hit winners every shot, Ben doesn't often do that.
So the only thing we can do there, I mean, Ben had the court wide open, and he's not happy with that one being called out. We do have it on camera, so we'll have to go back and look tomorrow.
Yeah, either that or he called the shot before that out. And then, because I think he called that one over there out, and he got, yeah, I think that's what it was. We'll have to go back and watch that for sure.
That makes a lot more sense if the first one's out instead of the second one, but that was probably the case.
You're going to get him right here, though, because, yeah, he just stepped up. Yeah.
Nice backhand volley. So that was a very
that's always held true, you know.
You think so, even like when you're shooting free throws and stuff like that in the game too?
Yeah. So. If it's a bad call and you miss one, it's because the ball don't lie. And then the Lord's just being generous and giving you one. How do you feel about all this Kentucky stuff that's going on?
Well, you know, I saw Scotty Grubbs up there with Bethany and his two boys, so he was.
See, I can't talk to him about this. I will not talk to him about this. He would talk my ear off, and I don't think I could. I don't think I could handle that because I don't know how he feels about it. I think he likes the new hire, but he, huh? Yeah, I know he likes Cal, but I think we all kind of like Cal, but I think it was time for a change. That's kind of my opinion on it.
There are a point in time, Morgan. I think it comes in life that you just sort of forget what got you where you are in the first place, and you forget about the fans, you forget about alumni, you forget about donors, and sometimes it becomes about you, and that's where I felt like with Cal,
yeah.
He had become bigger than the program, and he's going to realize the program is bigger than Cal ever was.
Yeah, absolutely, in every aspect, too.
So what was amazing, did you see that as soon as Ben Miss hit another one, that little slice approach shot of his just is not working. But
and these games are important as well because he's only down one. If he breaks right here, you know, I mean, if he loses both of these, the game's over.
You know, you lose this one, though, you got so much pressure on you because that makes it 7-5. And ideally, you've got to win basically
four
games in a row.
And you might even go to tiebreak, yeah.
So such a big difference between 6-6 and 7-5.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Can't imagine in a pro set.
See, I think the one that I always have to win, nope.
Ben Miss hit another one. He's just making mistake after mistake right now. And everything's on that slice approach shot. So that should be Jackson, so it should be 7-5 Flynn.
But maybe Ben will come back here with the serve that he just had, you know, that last set and or that last game and see if he can get that serve back. But also, what were we talking about before that? I kind of lost my train of thought.
Coach Cal and getting bigger than the program.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. That's – no, I was trying to say something about the set. So when I'm playing and the score is 1-2, I think that's what it is. You can either tie the game or you can be down by two. That is the biggest game changer right there. Because if it's 1-2 and you're up there and you lose both of those, that makes the score 3-1, okay? Or 4-1, or you could be tied. Like, that's a really big decision maker right there is when you're 2-1.
Well, I'm pretty sure C.J. Heiss took number 2 singles by the score of 8-3 officially over here. So that goes in the book for PC. So that should make the score 1-1. Looks like two doubles to end it over here, Morgan, and I wasn't paying attention. So let's see if Camden won or not.
Hey, Camden. Camden Tucker, did you win? Did you win? 9-7?
All right, so it looks like number 2 doubles won 9-7, so that's a good break right here. So we should have two wins and one loss so far. Now it's just all on number 3. It looks like we're up 2-1 for number 3 doubles, and it looks like Ben's down for number 1 singles, but maybe we can get it back right here.
All right, another one of those little half volleys for Ben right there, and then it hit it out of bounds. And uncharacteristically right here, Ben is having an off day. And so he's just announced the score 15-30. So, you know, he's only 2 points away from losing the match. So let's see what type of resolve he's got in here with him and what type of mental fortress. Yeah, just called 15-30. Okay, now we got double match point. Ben tried to overhit a backhand here, and yes. So, fans, this is not looking good at number 1 singles. 15-40, double match point for Jackson Flynn on court number 1.
And now if Ben does lose this set right here. That was a great serve. Did he get that in?
No, deep.
Ooh, that scared me. He's on a second serve now, but if Ben does lose this one, it's all on the number three doubles, which is a lot to have on your shoulders. That'll be out, so.
Okay, so add out. So he survived one match point. So here we go. The biggest point of the match is now this point.
Yeah. I think that might be 30-40, because if that last one was 15-30.
It's 15-40, his double match point. So now it's 30-40.
Yeah, that's right. How is he returning those? Put that down.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Wow, what a good shot by Jackson Flynn. And Ben hits a netter, and it just happens to go over on PC's side.
I call those hacky sacks. When they hover over the net, even in volleyball, when someone serves it like that, it's a hacky sack.
Well, you know what? And speaking of volleyball, which you know, Brandon Foister and I love watching you ladies play volleyball. That's one of the most frustrating things when you're playing back and it hits the net and it takes it off and dinks it right in that little soft spot. I was talking about earlier though the play of the year. Did you the first match of the season we played Somerset? Did you watch that point that went back and forth about six times each between us and Somerset, and we had to dive like three different times on full run one-handers and get them up?
So I was actually taking an exam at that time, and so I wasn't able to watch the game, but I did go back and watch it. I believe that I remember that. And you all were going crazy on the mic. I could hear it. Yeah, that was a good one. We had a really good season this year.
And, you know, normally that right there is going to win it for me for play of the year, but then we had just three, we'll say two, really crazy things happen this year. Sydney Martin had a shot at Madison Central with under 2 seconds left to catch it from about 40 feet. Okay, Ben Hampton loses match number one, guys. 8-5, Jackson Flynn officially takes it. So I'm going to call that an upset. I don't know the records for things, but I would say congratulations, Mark and Amy Flynn. Your son comes through there on that one.
Yeah, and Toby over there clapping. He didn't clap for the other win, so we'll see. But it does look like PC is up 4-1 on the number three
doubles. Okay, let's see if I can get in on number three doubles, Mark.
All right. So it looks like PC's up 4-1 on number three doubles. So if we do win this one, we will win the match 3-2. So it's really all on them over there. But it looks like they're doing a great job. And it looks like maybe we do have some exhibitions coming on. But also girls. Is it girls playing rock today, I wonder? Yeah, so that's on the singles. That's on the third court right there. So you need to go switch that onto the four if you would like to. Well, it looks like we can go eat.
Let's call three doubles for you. What do you say?
That's fine.
So if the match is 2-2, it comes down to this. Yeah. Whoever wins three doubles. It's going to be hard for us to see because it's all the way on court number four, and we got our equipment on the end of the court. But maybe we can try to watch through the camera screen here, or either way. So Murray and Cook. So there we go, Murray. Way to hit it, baby. What a great last name. You know he's going to be awesome. So ready to go. My little nephew is doing amazing.
Oh, is it really your nephew?
No, but
oh.
Hannah Murray, I call her my niece. So it's her little brother, Isaac and Hannah. Mm-hmm. So their mom is my optometrist. So, Tamelia Murray, she's awesome.
See,
so.
Hannah used to play. Does she not play no more? I don't know, she played last year.
Now she's full-time, like, high jump is her focus. And of course, basketball. So, she's a track all-star and basketball.
Yeah.
Okay, a little dink shot. And Cook runs and gets it. Hits it nice and deep. Good point coming back.
One thing I will say about Cook's, too. Gavin can drain those threes during basketball season, so knowing that his brother's also athletic does not come as a shock to me. But I'll have to go out here and see Mr. Cook play and see if he's the one that gave him those genes.
You know, we was talking about those play of the years, and I didn't get to come back to that. But Sydney hit that shot to put it in overtime against Madison Central,
yeah,
which was right at the buzzer. And then Brooklyn Thomas's shot to beat Rockcastle County off shooting a three-pointer and getting her own rebound.
Was that in district?
That was a district championship.
Yeah.
So she wins us a district title with that play. And then Harris Denmeyer called a catch over three Southwestern defenders in our end zone. That was an amazing catch. That was a ESPN Sports Center top 10. So we got four amazing plays that's going to go on there for the voters to have to vote on. And I'm just happy. I'm tickled to death to have those categories.
Yeah. And see, that's one thing also about the play of the year kind of thing. The reason is that was probably on top 10 was obviously it's football. They don't really cover as
they
much.
They didn't put it on there, but I thought it should be. It could have made it, in my opinion. It didn't.
Oh, they
it.
Did.
No,
oh,
no,
okay.
No.
I'm about to say it's football because,
yeah. It's a lot more watched.
I'll have to, obviously I can't vote on this, but if you send me the form, I'm going to watch them. I won't vote. I promise. I'm not going to screw that up. But
we're probably going to put it in like a actual video.
Okay.
And let everybody see the nominees for everybody.
Okay. That sounds cool. Yeah, that'll be really exciting. Yeah. Yeah, for sure. I really do think Brooklyn Thomas, though, has a really good chance at getting that play of the year. Like, because it did win them a really great title. I mean, it won them the district title. However, yes, it was a great shot, but it was kind of luck, you know. The other ones are a little bit like.
Looks like we're about to go straight out.
Yeah,
to
singles.
Girls
yeah,
matches.
Yeah.
There's going to be no JV matches.
Yeah, but what I was back to saying to the other matches, who else did you say? You got Harris for football.
Sydney Martin hit that shot at Madison Central to put it in overtime. But it's a regular season game, but it's still an amazing shot. I mean, it was from 40 feet, bank shot.
See, I liked Brooklyn so much. You know why I like Brooklyn? Because she ran up and got her own rebound.
Yes.
Not a lot of players do that. And that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to follow your ball.
Yeah.
You're supposed to follow and get your own rebound.
If the Rock Castle County girl blocks her out, she doesn't win the district. But she turns and watches the shot.
Absolutely. She's a smart player. She's a very smart player. And that's what really I think should win it. Because, first of all, she's being smart. Second of all, it was a great shot. And it won them that title. Now, yes, I kind of take back. It wasn't luck. She really did follow herself on that rebound. So that
hustle.
Yeah, hustle. Yeah. But, yeah, we do got a lot of good opportunities to see who might win that.
It's going to be fun. It's going to be exciting. So we'll let you know when we get the date for that. And hopefully our former athletes can come back. Mr. Cook's going to let us have a little green room this year. So hopefully we can have maybe some chairs and a TV set up to watch plays of the year. Maybe some cake and punch. And so for the nominees to have a green room.
Yeah. See, well, one thing I told Cook, I was out here at the last match and he was out here watching. I told him, I said, so why are you saying yes to everything this year and said no to everything last year? I said, was it because it was your first year as principal? And I said, you were just now getting used to it and didn't want to get kicked out your first year. Because this year, I feel like he's letting them do a lot more than he let us.
I don't know. Plus, you know, I'm probably asking for more this year than I did last year, too. Pulling that up for the first year is sort of a daunting task. So I think we're 4-1 down there, aren't we, looking at the score?
Yeah, 4-1, and they have served now. So it should be the same game.
Yeah, so Cook's got it in, and, oh, good kill by Murray, straight down through there. That's what I'm talking about, nephew. Way to bring it in there, baby. Pulling for you. Uncle James has got you over here. So good job, Isaac. Way to knock it down. So we got Rock Castle ladies warming up right here. So Savannah's got her shades on. Looks like she's ready to go here for number one singles on the far court. Yep.
Yeah, one thing.
Miss Savannah Heist, any words for the Maroon Sports Network?
All right,
so Miss Savannah Heiss, you guys don't get that every day, so we got our number one singles players coming up here soon. So,
yeah, one thing that I was noticing of them warming up is it looks like Savannah's a little bit more above Rock's level on this game, so we should be able to pull out a win here as long as we don't try too much.
Let's certainly hope so. So we're trying to keep it in touch right here for this number three doubles match before we switch over to ladies, just because it's 2-2, and that match decides the whole men's match against Southwestern. So first serve is a little short by Winston Cook. So is there any denying, Morgan, any denying at all that Winston and Gavin are Kevin Cook's children?
No, I don't say.
You can't make them look any more alike, could you, with things?
I mean, they look like copy and paste of each other. Seriously, it's that hair. Their build, like really, everything is copy and paste.
Yeah, you know, you mentioned earlier, and you mentioned Gavin Cook. Gavin Cook's nominated for our Breakthrough Athlete of the Year. So we got four nominees in there. So we went from averaging 1 point a game to 10 points a game.
So who are the nominees for that one again? You've got Gavin.
Breakthrough, I'd have to go back and remember. One of them is Kaysen Brock, just because he's a freshman running back that scored all the touchdowns for us. Another one, Savannah Heist. She's not lost a game this year, so a big difference between her. Is she a junior or senior this year?
Senior this year, yeah.
Senior this year. Okay, so big breakthrough for here.
and it took her this year to make that big and leap. What did she play last year? Was it three singles or four singles or one doubles? Or
she played one singles last year.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
and then Peyton Venters played two singles.
I wonder what her record was last year for her to jump up this year and be as good as she is and taking the leap next year. So I'm sure Coach A can tell me that. And I'll have to remember I think it was Chase Farmer. Chase Farmer's our other
I love Chase so much. He is such a good person, too. I do like Chase.
So his batting averages and home runs and RBIs and everything shot up between last year and this year. So we've got four really good nominees right there that I don't know which way I'm going to vote at this point in time.
You vote on those?
We let the students vote, and then I've got the all-star panel to vote, and then we average them together.
Okay, I like
so
that.
So it's me and Luke Elmore, Brandon Foister, Brad Woodcock, and this year I said, well, it's not fair. I don't have any ladies because we only did four men last year. So we brought in Melissa Woodcock and Delana Fothergill to expand it to six members this year.
Yeah. And she's having a baby, isn't she?
Yes.
I saw that. I was so excited for them. I was so unexpected, but I enjoyed seeing that post.
Okay, question is, did you watch any of our prom this year?
No, I did not watch the prom. I was actually doing prom shoots that day, and I was editing. And then I took, actually, Sydney Martin took her pictures, took a little bit of Malia Young's pictures, and went straight to Lexington for Declan's banquet. He got chartered into his fraternity that night.
Wow.
So, no, I did not get to watch it. But I will go back because I've watched our prom so many times. It was so much fun.
You know, Brandon Foister got sick this year, so Brad and Melissa Woodcock had to take over and did an absolutely fabulous job. So, thank you, Woodcocks. You guys are my heroes for pulling that off.
Yeah.
So, but, yeah, that's one thing. I was talking to Brock Green earlier, and he said, Mr. Murray, that's my favorite thing that Maroon Sports Network does is the prom.
Yes. It's just like no other school does that. I mean, not a lot of schools do live broadcasting through the school either, but who can say that they can go back and watch their prom on film every single second of it, you know? Especially, like, talking to the player, like, the players, I'm in the tennis match, talking to the students. I mean, a lot of times, like, obviously you have videos, like, when your parents were younger, they have, like, little clips. But this is so cool, like, for us to be able to walk in and just talk to you all. I love it.
Man, I'm watching Savannah Strokes right here, man, and they look really good, Morgan. Those two forehands I just watched are like, ooh, okay.
She has improved a lot this year, I agree.
So, comeback player of the year, then. I'm actually breakthrough player of the year. Of those four right now, which one are you sort of leaning toward? Don't you agree those are all four great ones?
I would probably go with Gavin Cook, just because the fact that he kind of was very, very quiet coming into the season. No one was like, oh, Gavin's going to be the one that's going to stand out. And then he stood out. And that's just kind of like, look, one of those things, kind of like this is no negative towards us at all, but obviously we all knew Savannah was good. We all knew Chase was good. We all knew, was it Case and Brock?
Yes.
We all knew he was going to come in being good. No one expected Gavin to come out like he did. And I think he came through, made so, like, I mean, I've never seen someone drain so many threes in a high school game, you know? And even with that pressure in region and district, he really pulled through. And I think that's probably my vote to go to him.
You know, it's so much fun right now because Brandon Foister and I got to call the game again on Rupp Arena's floor. And you talk about two guys in heaven putting us down on Rupp Arena's floor 2 years in a row. You sort of had to pinch us.
Oh, I know. I wonder if it'll happen again next year. What do you think?
God, it's so hard to three-peat. I mean, it's so hard to win one, much less two in a row. And now all of a sudden you're going to go for three. You know, it depends on what happens to Wayne County's players. I'm going to say that. I can't imagine all of them stay there with what they did to Rodney Woods.
Oh my.
And so do they go to Southwestern? Do they go to Somerset? Do they go to PC? Do they go to a different region? What happens with that bunch? I can't imagine that all of them go back to Wayne.
Yeah.
So to me, Somerset is going to take a big dip.
Yeah.
Somerset's out.
Oh, yeah.
Losing Ingrid and losing Gopi.
Yeah, absolutely.
So now, though, you still got your Mercer County. You still got your Bowl County, and then you still got, depending on Wayne County, what happens to them. But obviously, PC's probably going to be top two again.
Yeah, see, one thing about, I think, with the Wayne County situation is that, if I'm saying this correctly, you don't have to live in that area to go to that school, right? So I honestly think that people from Wayne County, they're going to go to Southwestern, or they're going to come here because it's not as far of a drive as anywhere else would be, or they're going to stay and stick to their
roots. Could be McCurry Central.
I guess that's true, but I don't know anyone that would want to go there.
Yeah. Sure. And, you know, if I've got to throw my vote out there, I'm throwing to the best coach in the region, John Fraley. Now that I put Rodney Woods 1, John Fraley 2, if I had to do my 12th region coaches. And I think John Fraley would agree that Rodney Wood should be at the top after 38 years. And he was one play away from winning a state title, if you can imagine that. One putback shot from being a state champion.
And well, they got him out of there, too. They didn't want him to have it.
Well, the reason they got him out of there is because Rodney Wood's wife did not elect the new superintendent 10 years ago. She voted for the other person. And so it's been a
And how is that any of his deal? I think politics should stay out of school.
I agree. 100%. And so, but a great guy. I mean, Brandon Foister and I love Coach Rodney Woods. He always brings us a folder with all the stats. He always tells us whatever we want to. I mean, the friendliest guy you could ever have as a diehard competitor, but he's knows how to treat the press and everybody else that's involved.
All right, so it looks like PZ's up 6-1, so do we want to go ahead and switch this camera to number one?
Go ahead and take it to one. Look at my operator right here. So, okay.
It looks like PZ's up 6-1. We're going to win that. So it looks like the Boilers are going to be 10-0 this season. Pretty cool.
So Morgan's calling it. She's already over here switching cameras. She's running Maroon Sports Network, so I love it. So I need to bring you officially in with the new merch. So you need a Maroon Sports Network t-shirt for sure. Savannah hits a deep winner right there. So let's talk a little bit about Savannah's match, and maybe we'll run it up to see where we go. Then we'll switch over here to – I'm going to assume this is number one doubles beside us. Coach hasn't sent me anything yet. But earlier he was
– It's Peyton and Emery is who that is. Peyton and Emery against the Rock girls for probably number one doubles.
Okay, so Morgan knows the girls team well.
I can't see Peyton being number two anything, so –
So we got number one doubles and number one singles going here at the same time. So we'll watch a little bit of both matches. But here in a minute, you and I need to get some food.
Honestly, she might be number two doubles just because you have Maddie and Macy. But I don't know. I don't know how he did that this year. Because sometimes they'll switch your number one and your two. They'll put number one at number two to try to 100% secure a win. So it really just kind of depends. But I don't see them doing that for Rock.
Yeah, I don't see, if you're undefeated right now, I don't think you really have to play around and juggle your lineup any.
Yeah, I agree with that.
You make the other team beat you, and then later on maybe you can worry about that. But right now you're wanting to play your best players against their best players so you can get seated higher.
Yeah, and I'm also going to go ahead and bet you that this doubles right here, when y'all see it in a minute, this left doubles, they're going to win right here. I mean, just watching, they're going to win. Peyton and Emery are good. They've played together all season. Watching these players miss hit.
Now, I don't know these girls here well. It's the one to our right here. Is this a Peyton?
That's Peyton
in front of us?
That's Peyton. Yes, Peyton Dennis.
Her calves are huge.
Oh, I know. I asked her when she started playing. I was like, did you used to play soccer? I don't remember really her answer, but she is built for sure.
It looks like she could, I don't know, squat or but those, she's put some work into those calves.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So that's the first thing that pops when I see Peyton from behind. So, impressive. Okay, so Savannah's here now.
They already won their first game 45 seconds into the match.
Okay, so we're switching sides, and doubles is up 1-0, just like Morgan said. So we're over here with Savannah, and I could have swore they've already played some, but they've not. Yeah, it's 3-0 Savannah.
Yep, 3-0.
So maybe watch two more Savannahs and switch over to one doubles.
Yep, I'll agree with that.
Okay.
Now it looks like PC Boys, number three doubles now, are only up 6-3, so I might have screwed them when I said that, so I'm going to take it back.
Uh-oh, 6-3. If it gets to be 6-5, we'll switch back over to that game, Morgan. So, yeah, fans, all of a sudden it's 6-3 in number three doubles. Savannah with a nice deep serve right there, so good job, Savannah. Okay, Morgan's going to go back right here just for a little excitement. We'll go back to, okay, we're back to three doubles. The lovely and talented Miss Savannah Highstiff with her shades on coming over here to see us. Ready to go. Good shot by Gavin Cook. Another one. Yes. Gavin kills it at the net. So good shot, Gavin. What about Gavin? Winston. So
it looks like a mini version of Gavin.
I've got Gavin in class. It does make it a little harder.
Yeah.
You know, one thing they didn't do, and did you do this a lot? Doubles was my game. Like, it was not singles. I love to play the net. I love to serve. But after a good play, quite often, especially like a kill at the net, we usually touched rackets.
Oh, yeah, you always touch rackets, but you never touch the frame. You always touch your one frame to the strings or the other person's strings to the frame. But, yeah, so in my career, I've played way more doubles. Coach put me and Kay Taylor together. I love doubles, but it's almost like, unless you're playing like a really good competition, like Bull County is really the only competition like we had super like tough. Sometimes we would lose to teams that just weren't as good as us just because we were playing down to their level. But Boyle County was really the only like game that I did not get bored in, because I like singles. I like running. I like getting up there, and I like playing for myself, and I like hitting all those shots. When you're in doubles, you really just kind of got to sit back and watch. You have to have a lot of trust, too, and that's kind of hard to have in the sport.
You know, one thing, Peyton, come look, she's looking right at me when she hit that ball that hard, so I don't know if she's got it out for me or you, but she killed that thing. But one thing we always did, Morgan, at the net, and you know, way back when playing, I like to cheat a lot, so I like to jump to the other side of the net off my partner's serve. So we'd always have a closed fist and open fist, and closed fist meant I was staying, and open fist meant I was jumping to the opposite side. So my teammate knew he had to cover behind me. Did you do anything with a closed fist or open fist, or how did you guys do it?
Yeah, so we didn't really have signals, but we would talk about it before the play, like if something wasn't working and we were down 40, we were down left 40. One of us would squat down in the middle of that line, and I would, before the point would start, I would say I'm going to go left or right, because the players that we were playing, they were either always hitting to one spot. They were always returning it the same exact way. So if they were always returning it to our backcourt, I would always go to that side and try to get it before they even got back to them.
Just let the players know something new. Close fist, open fist, baby. That way, nonverbal, right behind your back.
Cool. But, like, it's also another thing, like, if I was playing tennis, and that had, like, someone doing open fist, close fist, I would be focusing too much on the closed fist or open fist. I wouldn't really be focusing on the ball. I might mess that up.
Well, I guess it's a difference of playing enough matches together where you get used to being in sync with each other. You know, my senior year, we ended up playing a couple boys from, at that time, as Laurel County before it slipped over to South Laurel. And I got the unfortunate task of running into the number one seed in the quarterfinals. And they were twin brothers that had played together for, like, 6 years. So they knew each other's movements like clockwork. Things. So we lost 6-3, 6-3, and if I remember, I held my serve every time, and my partner did not hold his serve because he double faulted a couple of times with me at the net. That were big breaks out there, so saying things out there, but it was so much fun. I would go back and do my senior year exactly the way I did it, drama, yearbook, and tennis. Made my senior year so much fun.
Yeah, I had a yearbook my junior year. And my senior year was harder than my junior year. I took a lot of dual credit. So I've had – my junior year was tough, obviously, with pre-cal and all those classes. Then I also had a really tough senior year. So I didn't really get to have fun any year. But I had so much fun in high school. I wish I was still in it. I'm actually going into college next year as a junior. So I only got 2 more years left. This year's flown by.
Okay, good deal. I was looking right here. They stopped the match over there, and Winston Cook had to run outside to get a ball. If you and I were paying attention – look here, he's having to get underneath the building to try
See,
to find
I
the ball.
I can do that in the skirt.
No. I wouldn't want you to. I would be doing that.
Yeah,
for
you'd be doing that.
Yeah. So, let me go try to help him.
Okay. Literally Gavin Jr. They look the exact same. This is crazy. Looks like they might have lost the ball, too, there on court number three. What is his name again? We're on there on court number 3.
Sam Whitaker.
He just started playing
What's
last year.
Tackett? Let's get Camden's thoughts right here. He's
Camden, how did your match go?
Hello.
Stop. We watched you. Come here. We watched you play. But how do you think it went for you individually as a player?
I think it went pretty good. The heat probably got me a little bit. That's why I was 9-7. John David did pretty good. Really good. Not
so
pretty
you
good.
Won by a larger margin.
Yes.
But you let the heat get to you.
Yes. Yes, I don't get my emotions out on the court.
Yeah.
I keep it in.
You are a little sunburned. Remember that heat was getting to you.
He does have his hair looking good, though. If I got to say anything, the hair looks fly. So looking good for things. So Camden Tackett, everybody loves Camden Tackett. So great win, Camden. Thank you. So we should hopefully take this match over here to win 3-2. We're up 6-3. Yeah, deciding match. So, you know, talking about Cook and Murray over there, man, that last name Murray, he has to be really good, don't you think so?
Next
two, ready to go. So fun watching you guys. Hopefully we can do it again, Camden.
Yes,
all right, let Camden get some food. You're welcome. So we're up here, number one doubles, we're up 3-0, and number one singles, we're up 5-0. So Savannah may not get any more airtime, but we do have to get some on number one doubles here in a minute if we can get our number three doubles boys match over.
Let me tell you, one thing that is the worst thing that I do not like about tennis is when you're playing these pro sets to eight and you're playing against someone that's not even close to your level and you're winning 6-0, you just want it to be over. Like, obviously, they're not going to come back. Just, like, if we're being honest here, why do we have to go all the way to eight? You know, like, if it's 6-0, just let me take it, you know? Mercy rule.
Well, see, I got opposite thoughts on that. I love playing and winning 8-0, so I just me keep playing. I like to dominate the whole time right there. Yeah. So, but you always got the underdog. You can come back. It ain't over until that last point is over.
I know.
So I remember one match of ours, Morgan talking about that. We were down. We were the deciding match, and we were down, I want to say 5-3, and they were serving, and we came back and won that match 7-5, and we won the match 4-3 or whatever it was, and everybody was so pumped up. But it was, I think we're down 5-3, 30 love, I think it was. Now, I know it's not 6-0,
wow.
but still, you know, you're still alive until that last point of the match for things. So here goes Savannah, nice serve, ace right down the line. So, man, Savannah's got it going on. I don't know what's going on over here with number three doubles. How about if I switch camera number one over to number one doubles for girls, and we'll go back and forth.
Yeah, it looks like boys doubles, number three doubles, they are 7-4 now. So it looks like they got one more game to win it, and as long as they don't lose four in a row, we should be all right. It looks like they're over there talking to Coach Alfie. Almost said Coach A, but they're both Coaches A. And then it looks like Murray's going to go ahead and switch the camera over to number one or number two doubles? All right, we're going to go back here and we're going to get number one doubles here. Keep going. That's good. Yep. All right, so it looks like Peyton just hit a nice shot, Peyton. So it looks like Peyton and them are up 3-0. Savannah is up 5-0. We just had a boys' exhibition come off. I believe Sam Whitaker took the win on that one. And number three, like I said, number three doubles, we have got 7-4. So we need our boys' wins. One more game right here. You know, I was really confused on why Mr. Cook was out here watching. Then I realized it's his son playing. Just now clicked in my mind. It shows you how much I got going on in my mind.
Well, he was a former tennis coach, so he likes tennis.
Yeah.
And then maybe he's just here.
That's what I was thinking at first.
Maybe he's just here supporting student athletes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, he is pretty good at that. He did watch us a lot last year, too. Maybe try to see how the program was going to see if his son wanted to be in it.
All right. So we're here with, tell me our two ladies' names again, Peyton and?
Emery.
So I got to get Emery. What's Emery's last name? I'll look it up. So Peyton and Emery.
Yeah.
So right
Peyton
here.
Emery.
I'm just going to call Peyton Calf Venters. So PCV. So, God, what a forehand. Peyton can smack that thing. So she's got a solid two-hand backhand. Peyton, I see you, girl. What a good shot. She about took a Rock Castle County player out here and had to say she's sorry. So 3-0 and probably firm control of this service game right here. So here we go. Serving to Emery on ad court. Nice serve. Emery gets down. Good deep return. And that must have been either a let or out of bounds. So here we go, nice deep serve. Emery goes wide right, so serve that one. Returned out of bounds. So now we'll go over here. Emery's like, my bad, Peyton, I didn't mean to do that. So ready to go here, so Rock Castle County serving. And I'm assuming it's still 7-4 over there. If it all of a sudden gets to be 7-6, we'll switch back. Oh, nice. Peyton gets it up good and high. Didn't get the kill. Good job, Venters. Miss hit by Rock. So good return, Peyton. How much do you miss being out here in uniform playing for PC? I mean, you're getting old now. Let's just go ahead and face it. But it was just the other day we were calling your match. And I don't know if you remember this or not, but we come out here to call our very first game, and there's snowflakes flying.
Yes,
and we're trying to play in like 38-degree mm-hmm. weather. And I told Coach, never again.
No. Yeah. But that's one thing. He will not cancel a match unless it is thunderstorming or the governor has called a state of emergency. He will not cancel or a rain. Sometimes he would cancel for really strong winds because, honestly, there's just no way to play in super strong winds like that. But, yeah, I remember I had on my sweatpants, sweatshirt. I think I might have three pairs of pants on. It was freezing. And like, but I always play better like that, though, because I'm not too hot and miserable, but I'm also, like, bundled up, so I really can't move. So it really just kind of depends on the day, I guess.
I told Coach A, I said, never again. You know, we got a rule now from Rune Sports Network. If it's not at least 50, we're not broadcasting the tennis match anymore. So,
oh, yeah.
So we're looking for 50-plus. Actually, 60-plus is ideal. But we can handle 50-plus. But you get in March and April, and you never know. Just like last week, what was it, in the 40s? And now today we're hitting the 80s?
Yes, yes, yes. Today was 82, huh? I believe.
Starting to get a little better now. Sun's dropping down. We almost got perfect shade right here with this telephone pole. So 3-0 Rockcastle County serving. I'm not sure if it's 1540 or what it is, but I'm going to call it 1540. So we'll see. Coming to Peyton. I love Peyton's backhand. Look at this. Nice and deep.
Yep.
Called it for a winner right there. Peyton, I see you, girl. What a good.
Yeah, she's a really, really good player. She, like, and she works for it, too. Like, me and her said after a couple times last year, me serving to her and her hitting. And she really wants to be better, and she is a really good player. I love watching her play.
Okay, I know we mishit at least once. I know Rockcastle County's got at least 15, so I'm going to call it 15-30. Right? I know Peyton's won both of her points on her side. So first serve for Rock goes in the bottom of the net, so we'll be serve number two.
And we can't let Emery go unrecognized either. She started off last year, I think it was her first year, had like almost like never played. She just played. I think her friends were on the team, but now she's really came into it, and she really has improved so much, really.
Okay, looks like we're going up 5-0. We've already switched sides right here. So, Morgan, looks like we are in firm control of this ladies' match. They're really good. So, we're up 7-0 and 5-0 in the ladies' matches.
Yeah, and it looks like the boys are down there still 7-4. I'm not sure who served the first one on the switch. Do you remember?
I do not.
Yeah, so it's either 7-4 or it is 7-5 for PC.
I want you to come back sometime this year if you can and sit in on a volleyball broadcast with Foister Manor.
I would love to. I absolutely would love to.
Right. Well, depending on your college schedule, you know, you work everything out and see what it is. And
yeah, see,
you know.
I'm living with Hallie and Abby, and we're living in an apartment in Berea. So
really?
So we'll be close to home. We'll be able to come back and watch. Okay. And Hallie comes home all the time for Zach anyway, so I'll
I don't know why that girl would come home for. But, you know, speaking of, Zach Anderson's one of those too, man. I love that kid just because he is – Josh and Danielle have ran, and Billy Joe and Jason have raised an amazing young man, you know, because coming from divorced parents. But both sets, I love them both.
And very athletic. I mean, he is so athletic. He is a great player.
And I got to say, he's okay, good looking, with nice hair and nice charm.
Hallie would think so.
Yeah, hopefully she would. But, you know, Kent Mayfield raised some wonderful daughters, and I love Kent. And Kent's up for a coach of the year.
Oh, really? I totally see that for sure.
So it's going to be Kent Mayfield, Chris Atkinson. Or John Fraley.
You know who my vote's going to.
Well, I know you're going to be biased.
Well, it's not even that I'm biased. It's just that Coach Atkinson is a literal genius. So I think we should give him a vote for that, first of all. Second of all, he runs so many leagues. He runs the leagues. He runs all those classes that he has, obviously. And, like, he doesn't do classes where he can just do the same plan every year. No, he has hard classes that he has to make plans for. He also has obviously the tennis team that he has to take care of. Like, I don't know. I really don't know how he even sleeps at night. He has so much on his mind, so much on his plate.
Maybe he's not human and he doesn't sleep.
I don't know if he does or not.
He does have a lot on his plate for saying that.
Yeah.
So, but I know he's thankful for you coming today and doing this, and we all are. And, you know, you represent PC so well, and we all love Morgan Keith to death. And I know I'm speaking for Brandon Foister when I say that. So, you're amazing. You're amazing.
Yeah, he actually texted me the other day and said he was thinking about me, and it always makes me feel so good when Chris texted me too, and I miss this place. Like, this place was my home for so long, but it felt like 2 seconds, you know? You feel like, oh, 4 years takes so long. No. My sister's going to be a junior next year, and it makes me almost sick to think about. And I'm just like, I cannot believe. She wants to start getting into tennis too, so I'm hoping I can get her in there.
ACS, you're coming over.
But she's like 5'9", maybe 5'10". She used to play volleyball. She played volleyball the other day with me, and she actually did really good.
So right now, no sports for your sister?
No. She's PC won, so boys are still 10-0 on the season. Yeah, she retired from softball, so, yeah, no sports.
No sports. Okay, what's sister's name?
Kylie.
Okay, Kylie, you're being called out. It's time for you to pick up a sport. It's time for you to be involved. It's time for you to do all the great things your sister did. You're missing out if you don't play tennis, if you don't do yearbook, if you don't do drama, if you don't get involved with clubs, whatever it is. You just get involved
and
do something.
She did say it's very nice going home and just being able to go home after school and focus on schoolwork. But I told her, I said, yeah, but you're gonna kind of like regret that not being able to do everything. But honestly, hey, I don't know what going home feels like.
Look here, Savannah's a celebrity. She's over taking pictures with the Rockcastle County girl after she won 8-0.
Hey, sportsmanship.
All right, how about we go off audio and just leave video on, and you now grab some food. Are you hungry? Lions, we should be back live right here watching. And looks like, did the match just end while we got in here? Is that 8-2? Am I mistaken? Yep, match is over. So, I'll get ready to switch the camera. So, good job, Peyton and Emery, winning 8-2 and number one doubles. So, that gives the first Plasky point to us. Uh-oh, Savannah's coming. Oh, here, you talk to Savannah. Let Mr. Murray go off the air.
Okay, girl. This is my first time too, so you don't gotta be nervous. Right. So how do you think your match went today?
Well, it was only the second time I beat somebody 8-0 because I just like playing, so good.
Yeah. And you're undefeated this year, is that correct?
I guess. I didn't even think of that.
Oh crap, no you're not. We didn't say that. no, but I was saying, when we were watching you play, obviously like when we were watching you warm up too. Mm-hmm. I don't think she's at, like, the same kind of level as you were. I feel like we kind of have a higher, like, we have a deeper team than they do.
Yeah.
So, like, their number one was probably, like, equal to, go to your left a little bit. That's good. Their number one was probably equal to, like, our number, like, three or something.
Yeah.
I feel like you kind of had the upper hand on her there. But
yeah.
It looks like you did really good. Your serves were really good today. You want to talk about how your serves came along this year?
That's my second serve. I didn't even first serve. Yeah, I'm just trying to put spin on it because my second serve last year was like a little lob and they just killed it. So I just tried to put spin on it to do better when I play better people.
Yeah. Yeah, that's one thing. Now that I'm out of playing high school, the first thing you lose is your serve, obviously, because it's like a repetitive thing. If you don't keep practicing it, you're going to lose it. And so that's one thing you need to keep up on. We've been talking about getting you into the 3-0 league. Are you thinking about doing that or no? The women's league?
Yes, I am. Are you playing with Teresa?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I'm doing that. I'm playing.
Okay, perfect. So, so she'll be in our league with us. And what that is just like a LCTA league that is for 18 and older. And you also get to go to state and stuff. So we'll be seeing her there. And hopefully we get to play together maybe. I don't think we've ever played together. Have we played together? Like in doubles or anything?
No, we haven't.
I don't think we have either. So that would be fun to see if she does want to do that. Because, like, honestly, we could beat some of the older ladies. Let's see here. Who is your all's next match against?
Boyle tomorrow.
Okay. Yeah. Is that away or home?
Away.
Oh, that's not good. We need to be home. But Boyle, if for those of you listening that do not know, is a really good team. They are always our biggest competition, I feel like. And especially, oh, look, your sister's smiling at you. especially with our number ones. Their number ones are usually pretty strong. But I believe their number one actually was a senior last year.
They had four people graduate, but, I mean, their number twos are just as good.
Yeah, they're a very, very stacked team. But also, their facilities are super nice. They have four They have four on each side, so you could have four girls and four guys at the same exact time. And so it goes by super quick, but it also is kind of intimidating because, like, it's literally at Center Colleges, I believe. And so it's so nice. And so it's almost intimidating because, like, you're really playing on a college court.
Yeah.
So how do you feel that playing on that big of a stage?
Well, the bathroom's like a 2-mile walk, so.
And it's a porta potty.
Yeah, it's a porta pot. So go to the bathroom before you leave. That's what I'm doing.
Yeah, that is definitely the biggest thing.
But I like playing on it because we get done quick and we get to go home. So I'm good with playing at center.
Yeah, I agree. So what are your plans for after college? Do you want to play any kind of sports, like a smaller college, or do you have, like, any offers for anywhere?
I don't have any offers yet, but I did have center look at me when we played at Top Seed. But, like,
did you play good at Top Seed?
Yeah.
That's good.
I beat somebody 8-0.
Okay, that's good.
Anybody's going to give me something, that's where I'm going to go.
So you do want to play tennis in college?
Yeah. I do.
Yeah, see, you should look into the Cumberlands. They have a really good program, actually. They actually just won nationals, like, a couple years. I mean, like, maybe like last year or something. Katie Taylor's actually on the JV team. And so she, like, if I went there, I was going to play. He said that he could get me on there. But I would definitely, like, see if he could come watch you play sometime because it's a really cool school. That was my second choice in schools.
Mm-hmm.
And you're also able to play. You'd probably be on varsity. You are really an amazing player. So, especially like you're like, and also like your mentality. Sometimes I know you can kind of get in your head, but like we all kind of can.
Yeah.
So Yeah, I feel like also I was telling Murray, I feel like you've like really grown as a player too. Like last year, you kind of got more in your head than I feel did this year. Maybe it's because you were 8-0, but you really like talk about like the mental part of the game for you.
Oh gosh, well I actually pray before every match. Actually, most before every point, because like that, I mean that's just how I am. I'm like, oh gosh, please let me.
That is so real.
I do. Especially when I'm serving and I serve really bad, I'm like, God, please let me get to serving.
Yeah, like something so minimal to pray about, but I mean, like if it's gonna help me win, then if he said he would help you in your time of trouble, so here we are asking him for a time of trouble. Oh yeah, so that I know that we always do a team prayer too, and so yeah, that is very like a kind of a, it's a really good just like mental like. Like it's a very good motivator because like you feel like you always have someone on your side when no one else is, you know. So, yeah. Let's see here. So, how has it been being on the same team as your sister? Because she did not play on the team last year. So, how has it been being on the same team as Caroline?
Okay, me and Caroline are tight. Okay, so I love it. I almost wish we could play doubles, but I know coach isn't gonna do that. But like, I love having Caroline on the team. So
yeah. How different has it made your? Has it like strengthened your all's? Relationship, or has it made it, like, do you all get more arguments over tennis, or do you, like, help each other, like, boost each other up?
We just boost each other up. I mean, like, if we do get in an argument, it's, like, silly, and then, like, just go past the next point, we're, like, laugh it off, and we do, like, dances after every point.
Yeah, it's also good, because she's younger than you, obviously. Is she a freshman or a sophomore? Or eighth grade? She's in eighth grade. Yeah, so her and CJ are twins?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I forget that, yeah. Yeah, I was telling him, I don't know if it's your dad or your mom that gave you all these genes, but you're, like, really good. You're really athletic in two sports, right?
Yeah.
Basketball and tennis.
No, I'm not playing basketball. Volleyball and tennis.
Volleyball and tennis. Did you play basketball this year or last year? You played last year.
I played last
year. That's right. But still, you're really good when you did play. So, I mean, you had three sports that you're really good at. Caroline, obviously, is a freaking beast at basketball.
Yeah,
so, she's really good. And then, obviously, CJ is a beast at tennis. We were talking about, I wonder who gave them those genes.
Definitely Dad.
Yeah.
Definitely Dad.
I told him that also he has you all out here practicing all the time.
Oh, yeah.
But you all are going to, like, thank him for that one day because in four, like, the Caroline and CJ, they have 3 years left. They have 4 years
they're
left.
Gonna be so good.
And they're going to be really good when they're seniors. And they're also going to miss it. And they're not going to regret putting all that time in. So, what has kind of been, like, your mentality and, like, growing up in a household where your dad is really, really prominent about you all getting good and practicing? How has that kind of, like, strengthened your all's relationship, weakened your all's relationship? Like, how has that been?
Well, it strengthened our relationship because, so before, Caroline and Carter have been playing tennis longer than I have. I didn't want to play tennis. I was like, I don't know.
See, I thought you'd been playing longer than Caroline.
No. Sean literally used to play with us, and, like, he used to beat all of us. And, like, we would, like, play for, like, blizzards or something.
Yeah.
And then we finally got to where we could beat him. Now he can't play anymore, and he just likes to sit and coach.
Yeah. It's a little bit different, like, when your dad actually plays. Because, like, my dad, I would go home, and I'd lose or something. Uh-huh. And he'd be like, well, you should have done that. I'm like, you don't know nothing about tennis. Like, you ain't never picked up a racket. He's like, I could beat you 7-0. I went out there and beat him 8-0 one time because he's so bad. So, like, how much does it help you, like, be honest here, how much does it help you actually having a dad that knows the game and that knows what they can do? Like, do you actually listen, or just sometimes you kind of put on the back burner?
Well, he just kind of started figuring out the game because he played baseball. He didn't play tennis. But, like, with Carter, okay, I do listen because I know how bad I get in my head, So, like, I just, like, he's just next point, move on. I'm like, okay.
So, like, one thing about, like, I was telling him about, like, being in volleyball and tennis is, in volleyball, you have the, what coach told us when we were playing was, you have 3 seconds to get over that play. So, I let myself get as mad as I can. Like, if I hit, like, a ball that obviously, like, it should be, like a winner, and I hit it, like, right into the net over, like, a stupid mistake, I will give myself 3 seconds to, like, literally, like, be so mean to myself and like, you're stupid, don't do that, like, come on. But then after those 3 seconds are over, like, it's done and you're going to the next point. How do you work in the when you mess up so bad, how do you work in the getting over that and getting to the next point?
Okay, well, there's this thing and it can take 25 seconds before each serve. So, like, I try to, like, just walk back to the back of the fence, you know, like, I'm gonna smack my racket on my foot, I guess, and then get up there and, like, take three deep breaths and, like, bounce the ball until I'm, like, fine.
Yeah.
And I've got over it.
Yeah.
And then I'll go.
Mm-hmm. So, I don't know if this is just me, but – so, before I go into every match, this is just – I don't know it maybe just anything about tennis, but I go into every match and I'm thinking, okay, there's no way you lose this, Morgan. I mean, you have got –
I do that.
You have got 17 opportunities, okay, to not lose this match. It could be 8-8 and you're going to go to tiebreak. That's 10. So, you literally have 26 opportunities to not lose this match, okay? Now, I get out there and I start losing 3-0. How am I – or 0-3. How am I down three sets or three games when I'm literally in control of every single point? How do I let myself lose that many, you know? And so, we kind of get into it. And what happens when you're – you tell yourself, oh, like, how do you lose? But then you, like, end up losing. Say you're down 3-0 or 0-3. How do you move forward with that?
I got down 0-5 on Toray this year. And I just – I was like –
is that Southwestern player?
Yeah.
Yeah,
and I was
really
just
good.
Like – I was like, am I going to lose 8-0? I'm going to pull my stuff together. And just – I was a wall. I pushed it. I was a pusher.
And you went – you won, obviously, because you're undefeated. So
won.
You came back from 0-5?
Yeah.
Wow, that is really impressive.
I was so mad because I didn't do anything he said. I was like, sorry, coach. I was just going for winners, and she
– That is – I was telling Mary, one thing I saw CJ, and I haven't really got to see Aiden a lot, but CJ for sure has matured a lot in his game. He doesn't try to go for as many winners.
Yeah.
Like last year, he kind of just goofed off and wanted to go for winners every point because he was so good, and he is so much better than a lot of his competition.
Yeah.
But this year, the guy he was playing was really good,
yeah.
And so you really saw him, like, actually lock in and not try too hard.
Yeah.
So is that kind of, like, how you kind of look at it, too?
Yeah, except I just, like, I have to change my game for every player. Like, I mean, today I didn't do my first serve, and then against other people, like, I have to be a ball. Or against, you know, walls, you have to do winners. It's just,
yeah,
it's just whoever. You have to change according to the player. You can't just play one game.
Yeah. And do you, this might seem like a little mean, but do you ever try to get in your, like, players' heads on purpose?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I do. That's what I try to do every game. If I'm, you know, down, try to, you know, got to hit at their feet or, like, hit where they're running or just make them, like, sit there and run
yeah.
so they'll get mad.
And, like, and for, like, the middle part of it, how do you go, do you, like, whenever you're down, like, say you were down 0-5 against Trey, you obviously, you wanted to win and obviously you pulled out the win. How did you get in her head on that point? Did you, like, just look at her after you lost the point, like, oh, it doesn't matter? Did you make her feel like she didn't have to try as hard because you were, like, down 0-5 and you're like, oh, well, I'm going to lose it anyway. Like, did you try to, like, make her think that you didn't care? How did you go about doing that?
Well, I just wanted her to, like, I guess, I just didn't give up. So, like, I just kept, I mean, like, we just would hit, like, I mean, a lot of shots every point just to, like, till one of us got tired, one of us hit
yes.
the ball out.
Yes.
Like, that's what I did. Just kind of wanted her to get,
yeah.
you know, tired.
Yeah, and I'm not sure if you watched any of Ben's match earlier, but he was wearing, Flynn out. Okay, he, you could tell that Flynn was getting really tired. Obviously, Flynn did win. He pulled ahead, and he was ahead most of the match. But you could just tell he was getting tired. Now, with your technique, if someone's getting tired, are you going to hit shorter shots on them and make them run, or are you going to hit it so hard at them that, like, they just are so weak to be able to get back there? Like, what is your strategy there?
I'm going to bring them short, bring them back, corner, and short.
Yeah, I agree with that. You got to make them run. That's what it's really all about. But, oh, we've got a ball flying at us. But it looks like Caroline is up 5-0, so that's really good. So, do you all ever have, like, a celebratory, like, obviously, hopefully you all win today. Do you all ever have, like, a celebratory, like, meal that you all do at home or go out and eat? Like, what do you all do when, like, all of you all win, you play really good? Like, what is your all's, like, home routine when you get home?
We get a blizzard.
A blizzard? So you still get the blizzards.
Yeah, we still get the blizzards.
And so, it's that's the only thing good about it, like, your dad, like, if y'all were playing in the snow or something, y'all got free blizzards.
Yeah,
and
we did.
Y'all ever had to do that before? Like, have y'all ever practiced so hard during the snow? Because, like, sometimes it does flurry mm-hmm. here. Do you all ever, like, get those free blizzards?
Yeah.
No, that's good. Yeah. Yeah. See, I always wish that I had a parent that was really good at, like, knowing the game and stuff like that. So, yeah. And so, last thing before you go, how has Coach Atkinson been for your game? Like, how has he impacted your game and, like, your time just being in school?
he's helped me learn that I can't just play one game, because all I did the definitely freshman year, I just would sit there and just power hit it, and he like made me realize that I have to take some off sometimes, or put more on, or just like, you know, just be a wall and run them, or I gotta like, you know, just baby it over. He said sometimes it's gonna be ugly, but if you win, it's all that matters.
Right. Yeah. I totally agree with that. So, we're gonna give it back to Murray. I think Savannah's really wanting to go. So she get a lot. I'm just kidding. She get a lot antsy over here. No. It was good talking to you, Savannah. Do you have any last words?
Nope.
Hey. Well, good job today.
All right, Morgan, it's 6:30. We're about ready to wrap it up here, and looks like, you know, Caroline is following right in her sister's footsteps. She's up 7-0 now.
Oh,
so we switched over to court number two here, and I'll have to look up and see who's playing right here in doubles for us. But we jumped up 1-0 and serving here on this particular match. So.
I know that's Stacey Wesley. She's my cousin, so obviously I know her. But this girl right here, she played basketball. I get all their names confused, so they all came in at the same time for me.
Stacey and I don't have it. So is this like number four doubles?
Is Stacey on there?
Nope. One doubles was Peyton and
yeah, this might be an
Macy and Maddie, and three was Haley and
yeah, this might be an exhibition match. So it looks like Haley and Shelby are the last actual match. Oh, Maddie and Macy are still out there.
And Shelby's up 7-2.
Yeah, and Maddie and Macy are up 6-1. So the girls have got this in the bag. Are they undefeated as well this year? So it'll be 9-0 for the girls and 10-0 for the boys?
Or vice versa. I don't know which one's got more games. But one
well, we're undefeated. That's all that matters.
Yes.
Has PC ever had an undefeated season?
That's a good question. The archives?
We'll have to ask Coach that and see. See that's happened
first
because – But tomorrow is Boyle County at Boyle, well, at Center, and that'll be a really good match. That's always our toughest.
Yeah, boys and girls too.
Yeah, that's always our toughest. I wish I could go, but I have got so much schoolwork and so much editing to do for my pictures, I can't.
All right, Morgan, we're about to go off the air here. I'm sure the fans are thankful we did 2.5 hours of a broadcast, so it's pretty long here for tennis. But it's super fun doing this with you. Good to see Declan today. Good to have Savannah on the broadcast. Camden Tackett talk a little bit to us. But looks like we're going to stay undefeated here this year, fans, and hopefully enjoy the tennis broadcast. And maybe next time we can do it even better than this time. But sorry, Foster, I can't have a better co-host. So whenever you come back, I went and called you out today. Morgan can have a better co-host, but I couldn't. So, Morgan, why don't you take us off the air and any last words, and we'll get ready to wrap up the broadcast.
Thank you all for listening. I've enjoyed this opportunity, and I will definitely try to come back. Please try to get your all's kids in tennis is all I can say. It is a very good sport. It's a lifelong sport. Once you learn how to play, you can play for the rest of your life. It's one of those ones where you have tennis courts everywhere, so you can't always play volleyball everywhere. There's not always indoor volleyball courts that you can have access to. So it's definitely one of those lifelong sports, and you also make lifelong friendships. So that is all for today, and we will see you all on the next one.
You know, my other thought is, could we get Coach Atkinson to maybe get me one of them, like, zip lines, and I have the camera just going back and forth over the middle of the action. And so, you know, because right now we only got half the court in view, and the other half you don't get to have. So we need to advance our tennis coverage here. So keep thinking about that, Morgan. All right, thank you, fans, for listening. We're going to go off the air. So looks like boys have beaten Southwestern 3-2, and the girls are probably on their way to a 5-0 sweep of Rock Castle County. Thanks, fans.